For Lachlan McIntosh, capped off a brilliant season, scoring what proved to be the championship-clinching goal, sending UNB to seventh heaven. And now they're back, this time with a trip to the final on the line. This is the 2011 University Cup from Fredericton, New Brunswick. And game two of our semifinal Saturday is a dandy. The number one ranked team in the country, the home favorite UNB Varsity Reds, going up against number four in the country, the Western Mustangs, as we take you inside what promises to be a raucous and very loud Aitken Center. Hi, everyone. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Louis Jean. Well, when this tournament started just a few days ago, there were six teams, the six top teams in the country, but we are now down to three by virtue of what transpired this afternoon right here in this building. The Alberta Golden Bears needed to win by four goals, but they were unable to deliver the goods. But the McGill Redmen certainly did. They beat Alberta 6-3 to move on to their first University Cup finale in school history. And now they await the winner of Pool A. Will it be the Mustangs or will it be the V-Reds? Well, it's quite simple. The winner of this game tonight moves on to the gold medal game right here on Rogers Sportsnet tomorrow night. A huge game here at the Aitken Center, as you can hear the crowd. Can the Varsity Reds, the hometown favorites, deliver the goods, or will it be a monumental upset by the Mustangs? With more on tonight's tilt, let's send things upstairs to Peter Labardius and Sam Cosentino. Guys.
That's the wonderful thing, Sam, about one-game showdowns. They're not one on paper, and if you are the favorite in this tournament and the home team, the UNB Varsity Reds, you found out in your opener, you better not take anybody for granted. Not saying they did in any way, shape, or form, but boy, did they have their hands full on night number one.
Oh, and did it ever get scary. This whole building was on the edge of its collective seat, wondering what UNB would do. It came down to an offensive zone face-off with 8 seconds left. Josh Bailey wins it cleanly. Luke Gallant over to Josh Kidd, and the one time would prove to be the difference. 4.1 seconds to execute that face-off. From there, UNB would go on to the win, and a collective sigh in this building, thinking that, oh boy, we might be upset here.
Hunter Tremblay, he really makes a very well-oiled offensive machine go. A two-time now CIS First Team All-Canadian.
And you know, Peter, you really have to respect the career of Hunter Tremblay. A fantastic career in junior with the Barrie Colts. Comes to school, gets the school under order, but still has pro aspirations. And I know for a fact there are plenty of National Hockey League scouts in this building and have been for the course of this event to keep an eye on that guy.
Like UNB, Western, the number four seed, had their hands full last night with Cal. Won that game by a goal.
You know, it was very interesting. 90 seconds into the game, 1-0 on a Kevin Baker goal. And then in the second period, it's Josh McQuaid who's able to break in on a breakaway. The 150-point getter in junior B made it 2-0. While Brock Nixon would cut the lead in half before in the third, Julian Chimadamore would go upstairs. And Calgary had three great chances in the final 5 minutes. Western able to hold it off.
Baker was very good in the 0-9 tournament, too. He scored three goals.
Peter, this is a guy who's a pass first type of guy, but we saw a little different edge to his game last night. 90 seconds in, he goes down the ice in a 2-on-1, elects to keep the puck instead of shoot it. Clark Singer wants to see more of that, and I have a sneaking suspicion we'll get that from Kevin Baker here tonight.
To the winner, a date with McGill tomorrow night in the championship game, a contest where leadership will be big. As you look at the two captains, they'll be prominent. We'll drop the puck next.
The 2011 University Cup on Rogers Sportsnet is brought to you by Cavendish Farms, providing high-quality frozen potato products to Canadians for over 30 years. By BlackBerry, proud supporter of Canadian inter-university sport. And by The Home Depot, proud to support hockey in your community. The Home Depot, more saving, more doing.
Once I know someone has a BlackBerry, I'm pretty eager to trade my BVM pin with them.
That's the first step, is to get their pin and continue the conversation on BlackBerry Messenger.
You can see when your message has been delivered, when they've read it.
He's writing a message.
You can never respond too quickly. It's gotta be hard to get.
You can send voice notes, pictures.
It's almost like they're right next to you.
BVM helps you build a relationship and flirt.
Febreze Wooden Wood Candle.
I probably have one of these in every room. They last so long.
Nice.
You can even hear it crackle.
Also from the home collection, Febreze No Spill Wood Diffuser.
It smells amazing.
It's been weeks and we're still enjoying it. The scented oil travels up through the wooden block and out into the air. And no spills.
The Febreze Home Collection, featuring soy blend candles, wood diffusers, and flameless luminaries.
The Old Dutch and Sportsnet Net a Million at the 2011 MasterCard Memorial Cup Contest is on now. Enter the UPC from specially marked packages of Old Dutch potato chips for a chance to net up to $1 million. Enter online today.
The Sears Dress Up Look Great event starts this weekend. Buy more and save more, up to 40% on women's and men's suits, pants, jackets, and shirts, including great brands like Jones & Co., Ellen Tracy, Liz Claiborne, Chaps, and Hagar. Starts this Saturday, so don't miss it. Dress up and look great at Sears.
This isn't the future. It's Chevrolet now. This is Ecologic. It means more recycled content and fewer carbon emissions. This is peace of mind. Testing above standards. Making 10 airbags standard. This is the Chevrolet Volt. The first extended range electric car. Building cars for a new world and 135 countries around the world. Right now, Chevrolet. Driving our world forward.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm.
Welcome to a sold-out Aitken Center in Fredericton, New Brunswick. Semi-final Saturday night to the winner. A date with McGill in tomorrow night's championship final of this 2011 University Cup. Starting goaltenders are brought to you by Cavendish Farms, providing high-quality frozen potato products to Canadians for over 30 years. For the number 4 rated team in the country, the Western Ontario Mustangs, it's 22-year-old Anthony Greco. Greco 6-2 in the OUA playoffs with a 1.96 goals against average. And at the other end, 23-year-old Travis Fullerton, a product of Riverview, New Brunswick. And he was stellar in the opening game in the win versus Calgary. Tonight's referees are Brent Holdsworth and Jeff Hopkins. The linesmen are Mike McDonnell and Justin Burchell. These two teams played for the whole ball of wax in 2009 in Thunder Bay. The championship won by UNB with a 4-2 victory. A little revenge on the mind of the visitors. And the home folks, I think they're ready. Team lineups are brought to you by BlackBerry, proud supporter of Canadian Interuniversity Sport.
I get a look at Clark Singer in his lineup. He remains fairly unchanged from what we saw in game one. The same thing can be said about Gardner McDougall and the University of New Brunswick V-Reds.
Kyle Bailey waved out of the faceoff circle. The impressive captain for this UNB team. He hails from Tonoka, Alberta. And has the puck now. His shot blocked in front. Fillier is there, so is Nick McNeil. And Josh McQuaid, who's had a wonderful year in Western, fails to move it out. Hardy runs over his man, knocks Adam Nemeth right to the ice.
And Hardy was some kind of juice. We saw him yapping in the warm-up. He and Josh McQuaid going at it mouth-to-mouth, toe-to-toe.
He had words with anyone on Western who would listen, and most of them didn't want to. Greenside to Nemeth, chops it for Keaton Turkowicz. And again, it's Jonathan Hardy who throws another big hit. This is Josh McQuaid, a wrister that just missed. Baker off the end boards. This is the top line for Western. Make no mistake, with Turkowicz, Baker, and Josh McQuaid.
And there's McQuaid having his words with McNeil as he too goes to the bench. He had a mouthful for everyone University-like, University of New Brunswick-like.
Chris Corbeil, a two-sport athlete. He plays for the Buffalo Bandits at the same time in the National Lacrosse League, if you can believe that. He wears number 15 for Western. Culligan into the zone with Dean Todd. Culligan to the line. Ben Wright for Luke Gallant. Galata's shot, and in the shooting lane was Yasher Farmanara. Farmanara made a lot of good plays defensively in particular in last night's 3-2 win against the University of Calgary. Quite a physical beginning. Puck past Hunter Tremblay, and it turns into an icing call.
We saw UNB win a faceoff to win a game, and here after Bailey gets tossed out, he goes back, sends it to Hardy. A lot of times Hardy will take that puck down the boards. Instead, he runs the exchange with Bailey. That leads to a good change on goal, a shot on goal, and how about Hardy? Not afraid to step up and act physically as he takes a bite out of Nemeth here early on in this game to set the physical tone.
Two teams with 1-0 records. McGill, in case you just tuned into today's action, were 6-3 winners to advance to tomorrow night's title game. They knocked off the Canada West champion Alberta Golden Bears, their first trip to the University Cup title game. Josh Kidd, who scored that late goal, number two, to Lachlan McIntosh. He stopped up at the line. Jordan Clendenning, impressive, scored a goal in the opening game victory over Calgary. With Ryan Campbell and Lachlan McIntosh runs into big Matt Walters. Kyle Lamb to center, plays it on the wing for Steve Reese. And Chima Demore, a little impatient, turned it into an offside.
Gardner McDougall's the head coach of the University of New Brunswick Varsity Reds. And Peter, he had his team play in that five-game series against St. Effavax and was a little worried about the emotional start in game one against Calgary. I don't think he has to quite worry about that here tonight.
Sensational series for the Atlantic University title. Three of the games went to overtime, including game five, won by this man early in the extra frame. Bailey drives the net and was thwarted by Greco. McNeil got a piece of it, but couldn't direct it on target. Jonathan Hardy, little touch pass. Villier tried to hold it into the puck at center where Bailey runs into Keaton Turkowicz.
A big recovery there because Hardy's a bit of a circus. He'll jump up on the play, be a little risk-taking in his approach.
Bailey trying to make his way to the net. He's pulled down. That'll produce the game's first penalty. Marc-Antoine Desnoyer deflected out of play. And 2:58 into the opening period, the number one rated team in the home side go to the power play.
Kyle Bailey wears the C for Gardner McDougall for good reason. He leads by example, and here's the opportunity he has. Instead of going around the net, he says, forget that, I'm going to take it hard to the net. And he does the same thing a little later, and that's what is able to create the penalty. Held up on one occasion, gets it back, and is tripped up. And Greenside goes to the box for the hook, all because of Bailey keeping his feet moving and being aggressive going to the net.
First power play, Culligan, Hardy, Luke Gallant, Clendenning, and Hunter Tremblay, as you would expect, the leading scorer for UNB all season. Tremblay's pass thwarted by Jeff Killing. Tremblay with it again. Remember, he was injured in 2009, played sparingly in the final against Western. Tremblay, a hard blast. Greco didn't see it, but it went wide of the target. Hardy again, down low, Clendenning one touch, good stick by Killing, the former Belleville Bull. Played for Belleville in the 2008 MasterCard Memorial Cup. Into the slot, Clendenning had his shot blocked and cleared by Scott Arson, the length of the ice.
Yeah, a couple of different looks here for the UNB V Reds, but good job being aggressive for Western so far.
1:09 to go on the man advantage. Luke Gallant been bothered by some injuries in this postseason. And Clark Singer's team breaks it up.
Different adjustment we've seen. Clark Singer in the first game had the 1-2-1, and now he defends here in the penalty kill with a 2-2, and that's caused fits the last two times down the ice for the UNB V Reds. There's Clark Singer, who watched him in the hotel this morning making some video adjustments, and there's one of them that we've already talked about. Instead of going to that diamond, goes to the 2-2 here to defend in the neutral zone, and it's worked quite well. What a job Clark Singer's done, six-time OUA Coach of the Year.
And has a CIS University Cup title to his credit, one of the great games in history. A triple overtime victory for Western Ontario. Desnoyer to Kyle Bailey. Bailey will shoot it in on the ring, past Greco. Killing first to it, chips it by Josh Kidd, and swept down the ice by Kyle Lamb.
Ah, Pete, you got to love the cat and mouse. I mean, Garden McDougal sees that what their Western is trying to do on the kill. He adjusts and then immediately Clark Singer readjusts. This is fantastic.
Bailey to Marc-Antoine Desnoyers, who joined this team midway through the year. Former Drummondville Voltigeur, he played in the 09 Memorial Cup, and it's deflected out of play.
Highly sought after was Desnoyers, makes his choice here. But now, have a look off the draw. Here's Weston dropping back into its defense of the penalty kill. What we saw earlier was 2-2, and now we see that diamond, a 1-2-1. Once that puck comes up the middle of the ice, everyone is to collapse on the puck carrier. And it works pretty well because shortly thereafter, Western on the dump and able to send it back down the other end of the ice. Good job coaching wits between these two guys, Clark Singer and Gardner McDougal.
Singer's victory in this tournament came in 2002. Gardner McDougal guiding UNB to titles in 07 in Moncton and 09 in Thunder Bay. Dane Todd in behind Chris Culligan. Cross corner shooting. Paltrich off the boards, runs into Dane Todd, and Baker there to help skate it out. And Baker has no issue with that part of the game. He's a terrific skater. Western's number 10, Kevin Baker. One of several Mustangs who represented Canada earlier this year at the World University Games in Turkey.
Total of seven of them all together. UNB making its path here, not only as the host, but winning the AUS title. Defeated Acadia 3-1, and then in a fantastic series, three games went to overtime, defeating St. FFX 3-2 to become the AUS champs. And that is how the V-Reds made it here as the host and as the AUS champ.
Sam, you had to know for Clark Singer's group, the start and probably dodging all the early pressure would be key to that early penalty kill, and now they'll enjoy a power play as Josh McQuaid shaken up.
Desnoyers will go to the box, and McQuaid probably a target here for Western after all the yapping he did in the pregame warm-up. Puck chipped up by Nemeth, and although he's got his head down, the puck is nowhere near, and Marc-Antoine Desnoyers steps right into McQuaid and lets him feel it.
Desnoyers takes a seat, and kneeing is the call. 5 minutes and 40 seconds into this opening period. Western Ontario, based, of course, in London, Ontario.
Big sign here early on, Peter. UNB has won every draw in this game.
Arson blocked by Jonathan Hardy. The pass in the skates of Turkowicz, who had two assists in the win over Calgary here one night ago. McQuaid can't handle it, and here's Hardy jumping up shorthanded. Bailey and McNeil. Bailey a shot. Greco with the save and hangs on.
Good job by UNB, and it starts with a shot block and then the opportunity to go on an odd man rush, although Hardy was a little tentative in doing so. There's the shot block. Puck's turned over, it goes back the other way in what was, for a short time, an odd man rush.
Culligan, three game-winning goals for UNB in the postseason. It wins a battle for the puck on this power play. Out there with Gallant, Tremblay, or the penalty kill, pardon me. Lamb versus Luke Gallant. That's a pretty good tussle. Turkowicz joins the fray. Baker out there on this Western Ontario power play. Gallant trying to send it ahead, does to Tremblay. Tremblay, good patience to hang on to the puck. 44 points during the regular campaign and tries to notch his first of this University Cup. And again, stopped by Anthony Greco.
Yeah, great job. And you said it best, Peter. Patience by Hunter Tremblay. He realizes here that when he gets the puck at the line, instead of dumping it down, he's got space. There's a big enough gap there between he and Arson. So he decides to take it down the ice, get a shot on goal, and at the very least, gets that offensive zone face-off while UNB is on the kill.
Hunter Tremblay hails from Timmins, Ontario, an excellent junior player prior to his university career with the Barry Colts. 13 points in 9 playoff games entering this University Cup. Jeff Killing with 54 to go in the game's second power play. First for the visitors. Yasher Farmanara sends it in deep. Breton Stamler on the boards. Farmanara will leave it for Killing. Jeff Killing takes a look at Jason Schwett, returns it to Killing. For Steve Reese, who's made an excellent impact in his first campaign in Western Ontario. Baker, sharp angle shot that tests Travis Fuller. Jason Schwett down low, good puck movement here. Baker, top of the circle, and Steve Reese, he'll jam it on target. And again, it's Fullerton who goes down low with a blocker to make the save. Schwett in front, in behind Reese. Nice pressure by Western Ontario, trying to strike first. Killing a drive, that hits a body in front. Matt Fillier relieves the pressure and will skate it to the blue line. Both teams kill off the other club's first power play chances.
Outside crease.
Adam Nemeth up the middle to Jason Furlong. Juggled a little bit by Fuller. And the puck belongs to Jeff Lee with Kyle Bailey. Bailey avoids a hit, and Nemeth with a good play to step up and break it up in the neutral zone as Bailey runs into greenside. Clark Singer's team doing a nice job in the early going, as did Calgary on Thursday against this talented UND squad.
I think the game legs are back now. Western went 12 days before playing its first game after a loss 6-2 to McGill in the Queen's Cup to decide the Ontario champ.
They wouldn't mind another shot at their conference nemesis. It would be for a national title. Here tomorrow night, we'll have it for you on Rogers Sportsnet. 7 o'clock Eastern Time. 8 o'clock in this part of the world. And what great hosts they have been here in Fredericton. Clendenning. Denoyer tipped in front by Dion Campbell. Greco stopped it. Campbell from Melville, Saskatchewan. Clendenning. He takes a hard jolt from Jason Schwett. Campbell with Joshua Heptich, and the pass intercepted, and another penalty on its way to UNB. And maybe two penalties, one to each team.
Wow, and Baldridge thought he might be the guy to go, but we'll get it all sorted out when we come back.
Excellent beginning. Semi-final Saturday night.
For the career options you want, the top salaries you expect, the opportunities you want to explore, we can get you there from here, UNB, because there's only one, you.
Every idea we have begins with you, the way you connect, how you browse, how you share, and how you interact with the world around you. Down to the last detail, you inspire everything. Because in the end, innovation doesn't really matter unless it does something that really matters to you. And we are HTC.
All the freshness of Ireland is captured in every bottle of Irish Spring body wash. The legendary freshness of Irish Spring, now in an antiperspirant.
We were looking for new patio furniture, so we went to one of those designer stores.
Looks good from here.
Ooh, not so good from here.
No.
Then we got smart and went to Lowe's.
I just showed them how they could get a similar designer look for way less.
Looks good from here.
Oh, looks even better from here.
Like this entire Allen & Roth patio set at huge savings, available exclusively at Lowe's. And our everyday low prices are guaranteed.
I guess they're even more comfortable when you know how much you've saved.
I can vouch for that.
Yeah.
Experience. Lowe's, Canada's new home improvement warehouse.
I'm with Western head coach Clark Singer. Clark, not a lot of teams have the experience that the UNB Varsity Reds do. You must be happy with the composure of your team to start off.
You know, great job so far, especially killing off that early penalty. We got to try to get a little bit of offense here, get the puck in deep on behind their goal line and go after with our forecheck. But great intensity so far.
You're wearing a shiner. You're wearing that big ring there from back in 2002. A reminder to everyone that this can happen?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it doesn't happen very much. And, you know, we got a real good group of guys here. We just got to, you know, think a little bit about what's happening here. We'll keep working and get going.
Thanks so much, Coach. Guys?
Clark Singer has done a terrific job with the program. Let's straighten out the penalties.
I thought that was a hit from behind, but it's actually Diane Campbell with the trip, and then it's a hook by Julian Chimadamore at center. And so when the whistle blew, one side had one call, the other had the other, and we'll play five up here.
There is a lot of chatter going on between
these
two teams, and it started very early in the pregame warm-up.
It's pure filth down there right now.
Fillier having words with McQuaid, who's been involved in the majority of it. Turkowicz intercepts. McQuaid, a wrist shot. Baker trying to get to the rebound. Knocked away from him by Jonathan Hardy. And here comes big forward Nick McNeil, the former Cape Breton Screaming Eagle. Squeezed out by Killick. Bailey in a tussle with Turkowicz. Turkowicz wins that battle, but can't clear it to Baker. This one's not going to be for the faint of heart. Good. Bailey keeps it into the right point. Down low, Greco out of the net to leave it for Killing. And now Greco involved with 6'4" Nick McNeil. Baker will sweep it out of the zone, and Hardy back to collect it. This guy might play 35 to 40 minutes. Trombley with speed. Hunter Trombley! Greco, a good save, and then he's bowled over by Dane Todd. Who's going to get the penalty here? I think it's going to Brandon Greenside for tripping Todd.
And it is, and that's why Greco went down in a heap, because of the trip committed by Greenside. And great action. Trombley with a good shot there. Stopped by Greco. And then you'll see in front of the net, Greenside with the trip of Todd. That's how the goaltender Greco was upended. A good stop, though. He almost got it between the blocker and the arm. But at the last second, Greco was able to close the door. Greenside takes the trip.
The first-year defenseman from London, Brandon Greenside, takes a seat and a face-off win for Western. And they slam it the length of the ice.
And those have been few and far between. That is one area that Gardner McDougal wanted his hockey club to work on. Get to 60% in the face-off circle. It's more than that so far to start this game.
Offside will be the call. Second power play of the contest for the number one rated team in the nation, the University of New Brunswick. Jonathan Hardy from nearby Oromocto. It's about 10 miles down the road.
But played in the Western Hockey League. Now there's the glass separating the two benches. What's also interesting here, Peter, is that both teams are on that side of the ice. And so when the warm-up completed, they'd have to stop one team while the other team went off. And guys go off at various times. And there was yapping up and down that hallway. Almost a mess ensuing before this game even started.
Plenty of spirit to begin. And with so much on the line, no wonder. A UNB power play. Hardy to the front of the net now as he moved up. Gallant from Bedford, Nova Scotia. Bailey. Jonathan Hardy, Luke Gallant thought about it. He had an assist against Calgary on Thursday. Shot blocked by Arson to the corner. Reese scampered after it. Couldn't beat Culligan to it. Gallant, slap pass, well in behind Bailey, and an opportunity for Reese to move it ahead. He has good speed. With Furlong is Steve Reese. His wrist shot through the screen. Rebound, Furlong. Backhanded it over top of the net. Western Ontario with a shorthanded opportunity. Bailey to Trombley. Great move at the line. Hunter Trombley. Shot blocked by Kyle Lamb. Right in behind Greco and out the other side. A break for Western Ontario and a clear by their captain, Kyle Lamb. Another former Western Hockey Leaguer. He played for the majority in Lethbridge. Marc-Antoine Desnoyers leaves it for Dane Todd. Just onside was Josh Kidd, the game one hero for the Varsity Reds. McNeil. Nick McNeil. Top of the circle. Fans come alive again. Desnoyers! And Greco has been sharp when called upon. You're watching the University Cup on Rogers Sportsnet.
We're the Schultzes.
The brother and sister photography team.
Being photographers, images are really important to us, and so we'll try to take in as many movies as we can.
And Point is great for that.
It automatically knows where you are.
You're gonna interrupt me right now?
Uh-huh.
Go for it.
And it'll tell you what movies are playing around you.
On BlackBerry, it's a super app. You can watch movie trailers, purchase tickets on the phone. It's put in my calendar. It gives you a little golden ticket, and you're good to go.
Thank you.
More than apps, super apps. Only at BlackBerry App World. It's the BRP Ultimate Playground Spring Fever event.
For a limited time only, get up to $2,000 back on select BRP products, along with our lowest financing rates. Plus, get industry-leading warranties on Ski-Doo snowmobiles, Evan Rudy Tech outboards, Sea-Doo watercraft and boats, and Can-Am ATVs, side-by-sides, and roadsters. But you'd better hurry. The offer ends April 17th. Visit your local BRP dealer or brpultimateplayground.com for details.
For those who see the world as their playground, you need more than an ordinary diaper. It's why there's Pampers Cruisers. Its breakthrough super absorbency makes it 2 times drier, yet with less bulk,
to help you move freely.
It's the gear to play to the max. Pampers Cruisers, now with bonus diapers in every box.
With Gardner McDougal, head coach of the Varsity Reds here in UNB. And Gardner, great pace and great start to this game. And already there's both teams are yapping at each other, really going for it.
Yeah, no, I mean, you know, we want to play an up-tempo game and want to get pucks deep. We want to get into a game of races and play as much hockey as possible in their end.
You killed off 2 penalties. How important is that in terms of getting momentum for your team?
I mean, a special team is usually a difference maker, and we had a couple opportunities in power plays. We've got to get more traffic and more pucks to the net, but the penalty kill is a huge as well.
Thanks so much, Coach. Best of luck.
Yeah, excellent.
Guys?
Gardner
McDougal. He's about as juiced as the guys on his bench.
He is.
He's fired right up.
Face off. Kyle Bailey having a long chat with the linesman. And there have been a lot of players waved out of face-off circles in this event.
But everyone's been warned ahead of time. They're not going to take any advantage from either side.
Turkowicz into the zone. His wrister off the stick of Breton Stambler to the corner. McQuaid again dealing with Jonathan Hardy. They were the primary spokesman of words in the pregame festivities.
They sure were.
Kevin Baker's pass. McQuaid and Turkowicz are rolling puck. Fabulous pass, Turkowicz to McQuaid, and an excellent stop by Travis Fuller, his best of the game. Bailey enters the zone with Fillier and McNeil. His shot juggled and held by Anthony Greco. And as per usual, plenty of words after every whistle.
Keaton Turkowicz had 2 assists in game number 1 and almost picks up his 30 of the event. While falling down here in the middle of the ice, he frees it to McQuaid, and McQuaid gets a good hard wrist shot away, but Fullerton read it, anticipated, and reacted well, taking it in the middle of the body.
Turkowicz had a superb playoff back in 08 for the Belleville Bulls. A big reason they earned a trip to the MasterCard Memorial Cup that year in Kitchener. And he has been very good in this tournament. He's just a big game type player, that guy.
Always seems to raise his game when the stakes are raised.
Agreed. Lachlan McIntosh, you couldn't be any better than he was in the 09 championship game against Western. He scored 3 goals, including the game winner in the third. And he's out there now with Dion Campbell and Jordan Clendenning as Chris Corbeil tried to send it deep, went off the linesman, so Yasher Farmanera helped out. Farmanera is from North Vancouver. And it's sent down the ice by Clendenning. Clendenning might have been the best UNB forward in game 1 versus Calgary.
Yeah, he was fantastic and a spokesperson for the V-Reds after the game on the podium.
Go on. Finds Chris Culligan to Todd. Dane Todd into the zone, trying to cut in front backhand as he made a good move against Killing.
Well, Todd's been dealing with shoulder issues all season long, but now trying to put that pain aside and give his all out to help his team earn a spot in the final. Good quick hands here, the inside out on Killing. Greco follows him, but a good job by Killing at least to turn him to the outside before Todd got that shot in on Greco.
Greco's been very good. He's made 6 saves. Todd is Killing again in quite a tussle. Todd comes away with a puck. He's from Stettler, Alberta. Shot tipped by Culligan. Goes wide. Ben Wright pinching down to keep it alive. Culligan one-hands it back to Ben Wright. A rolling puck for the former Columbus Blue Jacket fourth rounder, Ben Wright. Kyle Lamb towards Julian Chima Damore with Reese. And it belongs to Culligan. Culligan takes a solid jewel. Kyle Lamb for Steve Reese. Intercepted and cleared by Luke Gallant. Greenside into the zone. Brandon Greenside. A lot of quality minutes for Greenside against Calgary, I thought, last night.
Kind of an unsung hero.
Turkovic battling for time and space. Hardy, an outlet to Culligan, who returns the favor. On his knees, right back up, Jonathan Hardy.
We'll hear his name a lot tonight, no question.
Well, you usually do when a guy never comes off. And that's about the third solid hit he's delivered to in this opening frame.
And he's not the biggest guy, but surely not afraid.
Bailey into the zone, nearly got around him and did, and just slid it by McNeil, who was by himself on the doorstep. McQuaid stopped up at the line. McGill with a date in tomorrow night's final. The winner of this game to play them. Bailey versus Jason Swett, who possesses the longest stick in this entire tournament.
Served him well there to get the puck off Bailey.
Looks like something Zdeno Chara might use. Still looking for goal number one. Bailey close to setting one up.
Cholesterol problems begin in the head, where advice about healthy eating is ignored. Observe as this man displays no reaction to the broccoli. While with hot dogs... But what you can't see is that high cholesterol is a risk factor for heart disease. New Danacol from Danone contains plant sterols. Plant sterols help reduce cholesterol. Find out more at Danacol.ca.
Danacol, proud supporter of life-saving heart and stroke foundation research.
It's your bar. How do you get your bounce?
I'm a sheets girl, but I don't just put them in the dryer. I put them in shoes, freshen up the car, put them in vases. Girl, I've been putting them for as long as I can remember.
How do you get your bounce?
Sheets, I put them.
The Sears Dress Up Look Great event starts this weekend. Buy more and save more, up to 40% on women's and men's suits, pants, jackets, and shirts, including great brands like Jones & Co., Ellen Tracy, Liz Claiborne, Chaps, and Hagar. Starts this Saturday, so don't miss it. Dress up and look great at Sears.
This period is brought to you by Cavendish Farms, providing high-quality frozen potato products to Canadians for over 30 years.
Well, the university game featured plenty of Western Mustangs. The coach was Clark Singer, Jeff Killing and Scott Arson from the back end, Baker Farmanara Turkwitz, and the goaltender Anthony Greco. Aaron Snow, who we have yet to talk about in this game, a key deletion in the lineup, was hurt in January, didn't have the opportunity to play in the winter games, and does not have the opportunity to play here at the University Cup. A big loss up front for Western.
And he was a player very instrumental to Western earning a title berth in 2009. Clendenning looking for his second of the event. And Greco with another solid stop off Jordan Clendenning.
Clendenning seems to make things happen every time he's out there on the ice. Does a great job at center. And here, head up, realizes that he can walk out from behind the goal line, waits for everyone to collapse down on Greco, and then uses that traffic to try and get it by him. But a good job by Greco to use that concentration to continue to keep his eyes on the puck and find it.
McIntosh, Clendenning, and Dion Campbell. McIntosh on the cycle. Clendenning plastered into the boards by Paltridge. And Farmanara away with Corbeil and Furlong. And Kidd, the big defender from Sunridge, Ontario, steps up on Farmanara. McIntosh into the high slot. It jumped away from Clendenning, but he kept it alive. McIntosh to the front. Greco almost got cut cheating. Farmanara with Fillier on the back check. Shoots it in, and Clark Singer makes changes. Just under 3.5 to go in a spirited opening period with a berth in tomorrow's title game on the line. McNeil spilled by Killick. Nick McNeil into the corner. It finds its way to Bailey, and he is given the business by Brandon Greenside.
He's been giving a lot of people the business, Greenside.
Gallant to McNeil. Nice take in his skates. Almost fell down, though. I think he's gassed. It's been a tough shift. Bailey scoops it down the ice, and it will be icing.
Oh, yeah, and the rough stuff continues here at center ice with both benches so close together. Chima DeMori involved with Bailey. The two will continue to have words. And the linesmen have to be quick in this one to get in there as soon as the whistle blows to break anything up. Fighting not tolerated here at the CIS level. And what that normally means is the stick work increases a little bit, and I think we've seen bits and pieces of that throughout this event.
A look at Keaton Turkowicz out there with Baker and McQuaid. The number one offensive threat for Clark Singer's Western Ontario Mustangs. Hunter Trombley, you could say the same thing about him in UNB. With Culligan and Dean Todd. Culligan rides his man into the end boards, and he's going to be penalized for it. And shaken is Scott Arson.
One of the University Games team members, Scott Arson, who spent his junior career in London, able to play at home in Western. And here Culligan gets the stick parallel to the boards, and it sends Arson awkwardly into the boards. Both guys really just fighting for position, and that little extra shove with Arson off balance forced him to go in there awkwardly. But Arson remains out there as Culligan goes to the box.
And a second power play for the University of Western Ontario. McNeil from the faceoff, charging in shorthanded. McNeil's pass. Bailey! Greco, a stick on it. Bailey, a shorthanded try, and Arson stays out. Made a good shot block as Bailey chops it back off his stick. Hardy stops Baker, and then a little forearm shiver.
There's a shocker.
Turkowicz with Lamb. Has him on right wing. Kyle Lamb tried to return it. Blocked up by Brenton Stamler and cleared by Jonathan Hardy. Greco watched closely by Ryan Seymour. Seymour, an energy player for Gardner McDougal. He liked some of the minutes he got from Seymour on Thursday versus Calgary. Delayed offside, they clear the zone, and Gallant takes a long look, clears it. If he hits Arson on the way to the player's box, that's too many men. But it missed him. 50 to go in the Western power play. A lot of tight games in this event, with the exception of this afternoon's game. 1-6-3 by McGill over the University of Alberta.
Yeah, three doesn't seem much, but it's been the most lopsided score we've seen in this tournament.
And we never expected that today. Lachlan McIntosh, is UNB doing a terrific job of killing off this second Western power play. Yeoman's work by Hunter Trombley. He can defend too. Finally knocked off the puck by Killing, and back comes Jason Swit. Swit, nice feed for Baker. Baker going down, and a good save by Fuller.
Little off-balance Baker, but earlier on the penalty kill, and the fans here at the Aitken Center just love it. It's a great job on the kill. Nick McNeil will step out and just tip this puck through. He's got a good reach there, and now he takes it to the front of the net. Tries to get it over to Bailey, and almost surprised Greco as he let up just a little bit. And here's Baker. We talked about him being a pass-first guy. Well, they're off balance, able to get a shot on goal. Surprised everyone when he kept it on the 2-1 to open the scoring in yesterday's game.
Baker in search of his fourth goal in two CIS University Cups. penalty to Culligan has expired. Into the last minute of period one, McNeil with Bailey and Culligan. Bailey to a loose puck. A former fourth-round pick, Bailey was, of the Minnesota Wild. He drives it, and rebound! Greco stopped it, and then he took a run at Culligan as he went to the net. Paltridge can't clear the zone. Culligan attempts to get to the net, and he takes a rough ride from Jason Furlong, and Furlong will be penalized for interference.
Well, it was Culligan who went to the box last time on the forecheck, but this time he's able to draw the penalty. Good chance there by this Culligan-McNeil-Bailey line. As you get a look at the former Cape Breton star. McNeil with the pass, Bailey with the shot, and the second chance opportunity for Culligan. And then Culligan just trying to turn away from pressure, taken down by Furlong. And now UNB here with 11.4 seconds left. Yes, we've seen them score in shorter time off an offensive zone faceoff.
Anthony Greco has faced 10 shots. He draw late. Bailey wins another one to Kidd. Dishes off Bailey with traffic through the steam. Culligan shot it right through the crease. Perfectly set up. They almost did it again. Differently.
It was 8 seconds when they beat the Calgary Dinos, and Josh Kidd was the big guy, but here they feed it back down to Bailey, expecting the shot from Kidd. It doesn't happen, and the shot right through the crease has Greco shaking his head, but unscathed here.
Play of the first period is brought to you by the Home Depot, proud to support hockey in your community. The Home Depot, more saving, more doing.
Anthony Greco with 10 saves in that first period, and here he has to deal with Jordan Clendenning. Nice recognition on his part to walk it out from behind the goal line, and a good job by Greco not to cheat off the post. One of 10 saves for the Western keeper.
Excellent opening 20. Still no goals. A berth in the title game on the line, and at least two more periods to come your way.
Pizza Bar. How do you get your bounce?
Oh, I'm a forgetter. I tend to forget things all the time. So I'm a bar person. I don't need to remember the dryer sheet. So if I forget, I'm still good.
How do you get your bounce?
Remember the bar!
I lost my child to my career, and then I lost my career.
City TV Tuesday. Megan Hunt is starting over.
I know a lot of MEs, and none of them are as big a pain as you are.
Already, we agree on something.
She's the best around.
The knives will come out the minute you screw up.
Think you can get away with murder?
Like that's gonna happen?
Overheard dead bodies.
Don't believe everything you've heard about me. Truth is much worse.
Body of Proof. Premieres 10 Tuesday on City TV.
McDouble. What for?
Just taking care of my roommate. Up.
The delicious McDouble, only $1.39 every day.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven.
Ivanka Osnak in the Connected Studios with this update. Second period action coming right up, but first a very busy day on this Saturday. Let's check out the other semifinal action between University of Alberta and McGill. Red Wing coming in motivated. First period, puck comes to Guillaume Doucette. He feeds Francois Veropo who buries it into the open net, 1-0. Just over a minute later, Bears, they can't keep the puck in. Maxime Langelet-Perron sprung on the breakaway and makes good on it as he snaps it home. He had two markers on the day. It's a 2-0 lead. Now 3-1 in the second. McGill looking for more 3-on-2. And Evan Vossen snipes off the post and in. They go up 4-1 and go on to win it. 6-3, advancing to their first cup final in school history, and they will wait to see who wins the other semi-game. Meanwhile, in the pros, Rangers, Bruins, just 2:44 into the game, Sean Avery, he's looking for a dance partner. He finds one in Gregory Campbell. The two trading punches, doing a little spinning, dancing. Nothing serious, though. We'll call it a draw. Avery would end up going to the dressing room, injuring his hands. Less than 4 minutes later, Michael Sauer lets the wrister go from the blue line, and Derek Steppen with the great tip. Nice redirect. Rangers, that's all they needed as they take this one over Boston, 1-0. Meanwhile, over on the West Coast, the Avalanche and Kings, second period, LA already up 2-0, and potential disaster news for LA. Andre Kopitar taken down awkwardly, seems to have fallen into a rut there. Falls on top of his right ankle. He was down for several moments before being helped off. He has a fractured ankle. Late in the second, though, Avs looking to get on the board. Paul Stastny feeds Milan Hejduk. His 11th consecutive 20-goal season. That ties Joe Sakic's franchise record, Colorado, trailing 2-1. Early in the third, Kings put it away. Ryan Smith working behind the net and the spin move as he jams it past Peter Budaj. Kings, they win a costly one, though, 4-1. Meanwhile, hoops action. Second half, Butler. After being down by as many as 11, they claw their way back. Sheldon Mack displays the nasty Eurostep, then drives the lane and goes window and in. This game is all tied. Jump to the dying seconds. We're tied at 60. Irvin Walker with a chance to win it, but his three ball rims out, sending it into overtime. In the extra cue, after Mack put Butler up by 3 on free throws, Walker, he's got a chance to extend it, but his shot rims out. So Butler, they're going back to the Final Four, taking it 74-71. Don't forget, Phil, Mr. Wonderful Davis takes on Antonio Rogério Nogueira tonight, UFC Fight Night 24, and you can see it across the board. Sportsnet East, Ontario, West Pacific tonight. That's coming your way at 10 p.m. Eastern. For now, enjoy the hockey game.
For the money you can make and the places you can travel. While you earn your degree, we can get you there from here, UNB, because there's only one you.
Once I know someone has a BlackBerry, I'm pretty eager to trade my BBM pin with them.
That's the first step, is to hit their pin and continue the conversation on BlackBerry Messenger.
You can see when your message has been delivered, when they've read it.
He's writing a message.
You can never respond too quickly. Try to be hard to get.
You can send voice notes, pictures.
It's almost like they're right next to you.
BBM helps you build a relationship and flirt.
This winter, fuel up at FastGas Plus and enter to win one of 10 free vacations. Fill out a ballot at any FastGas Plus location. You could be the next vacation winner. Plus, save 3 cents per liter and get cash back with your liter log. Visit FastGasPlus.ca for details.
Got a tough job to do? Make it easier with a rugged new Home Gardener Mule. Only at Home Hardware and Building Center locations. 2 pneumatic tires keep it stable, so it rolls easily. It quickly converts to a hand truck. You can move heavy pots, shift rocks, and much more. It's tough and versatile, and it's easy to transport. The Home Gardener Mule, only at Home Hardware and Building Center locations. Homeowners helping homeowners.
The crowd is cheering. Your heart is pounding. $1 million is up for grabs. The Old Dutch and Sportsnet Net a Million of the 2011 MasterCard Memorial Cup Contest is back. Enter the UPC from specially marked packages of Old Dutch potato chips. 3 lucky winners will compete live at the MasterCard Memorial Cup on May 29th for a chance to net $100,000, $250,000, or $1 million. Other prizes include a $5,000 package from The Brick and $500 cash from Old Dutch for every go. Enter online today.
What's in a brushstroke? Look closely and you'll see the dynamic power and craftsmanship present in every vehicle we build. What's in a brushstroke? Everything you'll feel when you drive the new Infiniti G25. The latest in the legendary G-Line. This is inspired performance This is the way of Infinity. Right now, take advantage of incredible offers on the Infinity lineup.
Be sure to tune in to Rogers Sportsnet on Sunday night for our finale here at the University Cup from Fredericton, New Brunswick. McGill is already in, but who between Western and UNB will they face? That is the big question as we take you back inside the Aitken Center in Fredericton, New Brunswick. I'm joined by the Western Mustangs captain, Kyle. Tell me about that first period. It really was intense from the get-go, even in the warm-up.
Yeah, you know, it was a very high-paced game. Both teams came out hitting hard and getting every shot to the net. And, you know, it was very high pace. We just got to keep going.
Towards the end, it seemed as though UNB was kind of taking it too. What do you think Clark Singer is going to say between periods one and two to calm you guys down a little bit?
You know, we really got into penalty trouble there. We got to stay out of the box. And, you know, I thought we did a great job in our D-zone. We stayed really composed. But, you know, we got to continue to shoot. I don't think we got enough shots there. We got to get on their goalie more and go from there.
How much do you use 2009 as motivation when you lost to UNB in the University Cup Final?
You know, it's tough. We try not to look back too much at that. But, you know, we knew coming into this tournament, them as the number one seed, that this game was going to be tough for us. And, you know, it's been a great game so far, but we'll see what happens.
Your girlfriend's father is Dave Lowry, the former captain of the Calgary Flames. Tell me about what the advice he gave you, because I thought it was interesting in a conversation we had earlier in this tournament.
Yeah, I know Dave's been quite the inspiration for me my whole career. So he just told me go out every shift and do something that someone will remember. So, you know, he's a great influence on me and on my team. He's helped me a lot with my leadership. So, yeah, thank you.
Well, thanks so much for this. Best of luck the rest of the way.
Thanks very much, guys.
All right, that's Kyle Lamb, captain of the Mustangs. This game is tied after 20 minutes of play. We'll be right back. The University Cup on Rogers Sportsnet.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm
Music provided by Universal Canada. entertaining first period in the book, Sam. No goals. Some good work by the Netminders.
Yeah, they were fantastic in that first period of play. Western testing Fullerton on a couple of occasions. We had four scoring chances for the Mustangs in that first period of play. Meanwhile, at the other end of the ice, was Anthony Greco doing his part for the Western Mustangs. Looked shaky on a couple of occasions, but we had nine grade A scoring chances on the books for the UNB Varsity Reds, including this one from Clendenning, which I thought was his best save in that first period of play. Culligan also getting involved. Dane Todd doing a good job to take it net side, but again, Greco there to cover things up. He has been solid all season long.
First period scoring summary is brought to you by BlackBerry, proud supporter of Canadian Interuniversity Sport.
A couple of power plays for each side, and the UNBV Reds leading in the shots on goal department.
And the University of New Brunswick will start period two with 1:49 left on their third power play. The Varsity Red mascot, they call him Prospect.
Did you know that James Naismith, the inventor of basketball, was a McGill alumnus? And that indoor ice hockey was first played by McGill students in 1875? Football had its beginnings in a game played between McGill and Harvard back in 1874. Over the past century, McGill athletes have combined to win 7 university national championships, 28 Olympic medals, and 31 Stanley Cup titles. Who knows what future remarkable achievements await our student athletes?
How long have you been here?
A few hours.
Why don't you grab a coffee? I'll take over.
It's all yours.
So you're a tough guy, huh? Listen, Ricky. You finish that dinner, you're a free man.
When they won't eat at your table, bring them to ours. BP Kids Meals at Boston Pizza.
And welcome back inside the building here. University Cup. The winner tonight moves on to the gold medal game. And I'm joined by the associate coach of the UNB Varsity Reds, Todd Sparks, former captain of the team. And what was the message after period one?
Kind of keep doing what we're doing. We're pretty happy with our legs. I think we can put the pucks a little deeper behind their D, maybe a little more movement, neutral zone, and obviously maybe put a few more pucks on net.
Gardner was concerned with the emotional level after game one, but I mean, right from the warm-up, it was clear that would not be a problem between these two teams.
No, I mean, both teams, I think there's a little history there going back a couple years, and yeah, both teams are going at it pretty hard, and I say the intensity level is right up there.
And it seems, you know, with the TV timeouts, is it beneficial for both teams to kind of get that time off and be able to use some of your top guys a little bit more?
I think so. When you get to these games, you know, it's good to have that experience and knowing you know, when to put those top guys out at that moment, when you can have those six-minute, four-minute sprints. And, yeah, both teams, I think, are doing a good job.
How much pressure is on the home team, given the fact that you have such tremendous support here in Fredericton, but everybody expects you guys to crush the opposition? And, of course, anything but a gold medal is a disappointment here.
Yeah, I mean, that's our expectation every year. That's kind of a neat thing where the program has come. So, you know, we're looking to do our best, obviously, and I think we'll have a really good period.
Best of luck the rest of the way. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Louie.
Guys?
Well, Todd Sparks, the associate coach, as Jonathan Hardy comes back out onto the ice. Gardner McDougall also getting help on his bench.
They have done a terrific job here in Fredericton with this program. This is their 11th appearance in this University Cup tournament. Three-time champions. Their first victory came back in 1998 in Saskatoon when they beat the University of Acadia 6-3. The coach at that time for Acadia is now the athletic director, Kevin Dickey, here at the University of New Brunswick.
And you know what, Peter? It's really a good program that they have here in that they are the game in town. And you walk around town, you see the signs up. There's no professional teams here. It's all about CIS hockey. So you can't think of a better place to host this event than right here in UNB, where it is indeed the focus. 11 appearances, 3 championships. Competed in the championship game 7 times. And a win over Western in 09. The last University Cup to be hoisted by the UNBV Reds.
And the last time this tournament was played in this building, 2004. They were in the championship game that year and lost to arch rival St. FX, Danny Flynn's team at that time, in double overtime in the final on a goal by Blake Robson.
And don't you think, Peter, that coming into this event, that a lot of people around town and maybe in Antigonish figured that this was going to be the same sort of setup, that those two teams would meet in the final?
I do indeed. And I don't think only the people in this area felt that way necessarily. Go on. UNB with their third power play to open this second period. McGill winners today earlier to advance to their first ever title game. Culligan just missed Jonathan Hardy. Good stick and recovery by Kyle Lamb, who dropped down low defensively. Hunter Tremblay to Luke Gallant. And Jonathan Hardy. Gallant, one-timer. Ouch. And I mean ouch. As it hit Jeff Killing, and you can hear him yell up here. Tremblay with a little room to operate. Another block, this one by Arson. Gallant keeps it in again. Moves laterally. Another shot block. This one, Farmanara. Culligan hit a broken stick. Greco robbed Hardy on the backhand.
Good save by the broken stick.
Culligan again. No stick for Arson. Lamb got a piece. Gallant. Culligan. Gallant again. Unbelievable play by Lamb.
That's a four spot here on the kill. Four block shots by Western. Good sacrifice.
Culligan enters the zone again on this power play. 20 seconds left in it. Gallant and Tremblay for Chris Culligan. Tremblay down low for Hardy. And Greenside tied him up efficiently enough to prevent a shot. Gallant, Hardy. Jonathan Hardy making shot block number five. This one, Brandon Greenside, and Western selling out to kill off the Furlong penalty. Offside, the call.
Well, you can't say it any better. Great defensive play, and it all starts with the captain, Kyle Lamb, doing a great job here. Comes back to take the stick away from Hardy. Puck goes through the zone, and then Jeff Killing sacrificing his body in front of the net. Luke Gallant can shoot it a ton, but Killing takes it right in the midsection. He doesn't get off the ice. He gets back up, and then Kyle Lamb finishing it off with the fifth block shot on that penalty kill for Western. What a great job team-wide, and that can really inspire you moving forward as the penalty has been killed off.
The fourth-year forward from Port Coquitlam, British Columbia, Kyle Lamb. That's leadership. McQuaid has to let it go. Western clears the zone. Another tightly contested contest at this 2011 University Cup. Brenton Stamler slides it. McQuaid leaves it for Sweat. Knocked down by the glove of McNeil. And he'll backhand it to Clendenning. Denoyer joins the rush. Marc-Antoine Denoyer to Jordan Clendenning. With Dean Todd. Todd was good in that first period. Stripped by Baker. Here comes that great speed. Kevin Baker with McQuaid. McQuaid off the goalpost. Josh McQuaid takes the pass and rips it. Doink right off the iron.
Well, Pete, and you watch McQuaid here in a couple of games we've seen him, and you wonder how he wasn't a star in Major Junior. He had 150 points to set the record in the Midwestern Junior B League in Ontario. Here, he knows full well he's going to get the pass from Baker. Very calm slide across by Fullerton. Doesn't give up anything, and it forces McQuaid to have to be picture perfect. All he could get was iron, because that's all there was available.
Josh McQuaid that close to his second in this University Cup. McIntosh enters the zone. Lachlan McIntosh. He doesn't want this to be his final game in his university career. The hero of the 09 final against this same Western group. Well, not exactly the same. A lot of guys left over, though, on both sides. Dion Campbell scoops it to the line. Steve Reese away from Seymour, and now gives it away to McIntosh. Lachlan McIntosh for Seymour, and Julian Chima Demore came back defensively to break that up. Chima Demore into the zone. Randy Hannigan, a rare shift. Tremblay in hot pursuit of Arson, paired with Killick. The number one pairing for Clark Singer on defense. Dean Todd, a shoulder check in the corner. And Arson, pretty steady defender, always has been. Off his skate and down the ice with Furlong bearing down on Marc-Antoine Desnoyers. Corbeil clutch, there'll be a penalty to Kidd.
Don't worry about Corbeil. No. He's tougher than nails, this guy. Josh Kidd is a big guy, and here he erases Corbeil, but absolutely no chance it was going to bother the tough lacrosse player. Good job here by Julian Chimadamore as he comes all the way back and is able to get in the lane and take that puck away. And then you'll see Josh Kidd working against Corbeil. The puck has already been moved away from the area, and Corbeil has seen that once or twice, but not on skates, on foot, as Kidd gets the gate for interference.
Josh Kidd in a third power play opportunity for the Western Ontario Mustangs. Baker off the stick of Kyle Bailey to Kyle Lamb. Baker holds it into the right point. Lamb, McQuaid out there. Turkowicz to the front of the net. Arson, Baker, one touch pass to McQuaid. Josh McQuaid bothered by Jonathan Hardy. UNB very aggressive on the kill, and it pays dividends, maybe more so. McNeil and Arson, a nice recovery against the lanky Nick McNeil. McQuaid, a hard wrister. Fullerton the save, and a clear by Bailey.
Well, we saw a great kill from Western. UNB trying to do the same at the other end.
Ben Wright to Stamler, former Western Hockey Leaguer. Ryan Seymour into the zone against Arson. Seymour takes a bump in the corner, and this is Turkowicz. A minute to go on the power play. Just past the five-minute mark of period two in what truly is a semifinal affair. Matt Villier pounds the puck. Intercepted, Culligan might get away shorthanded. He's got a couple of those in the playoffs. Scores! Chris Culligan gives UNB the lead.
When in doubt, you have to get the puck deep, and here it's turned over. What is to be a D-to-D pass on the far D wide ends up getting picked off by Chris Culligan. Anticipation by Culligan to pick this pass off, and from there he is off to the races. A good job by Killing to try and get back, but he cannot thwart the attack of Chris Culligan. You mentioned it, Peter. He's done it before. He's such a smart player. That's why you can use him in all situations. Culligan in perfect position. And great finish.
The pride of Howie Center, Nova Scotia, has his second postseason shorthanded goal. He scored one in the Atlantic University playoffs and has opened the scoring in this large encounter for the home team. And made no mistake on the breakaway. Kelly McNeil tries to rub him off the end boards. Swift looking to regain some composure for this Western team with time winding down on the power play. Baker fans in a pass. And you know what they're chanting? UNB. Reese into the zone. Nice move against Desnoyers. Reese stays with it. Spinning and twisting. Double teamed. Culligan this time with another defensive jam. And Desnoyers, look out, over the glass, over the beam, and out of play. You know what they say about the Culligan man? He's everywhere.
Once I know someone has a BlackBerry, I'm pretty eager to trade my BBM pin with them.
That's the first step, is to get their pin and continue the conversation on BlackBerry Messenger.
You can see when your message has been delivered, when they've read it.
He's writing a message.
You can never respond too quickly. It's gotta be hard to get.
You can send voice notes, pictures.
It's almost like they're right next to you.
BBM helps you build a relationship and flirt.
I parked my snowmobile right out there. There was a crack like thunder, but suddenly it was gone, like it never existed. What goes on beneath the ice in this river is a mystery won't never be solved. It's like an enigma, wrapped up in a conundrum inside of a furry blanket of I don't know what.
Stay clear, stay safe.
A message from the Ontario Provincial Police and Ontario Power Generation.
Canadians have no problem being out in the cold. No self-respecting Canadian says, let's wait for a warmer day. Here, braving the cold is a national sport. You and your clothes embrace cold weather. Why not wash them in cold water? Tide does better at getting stains out in cold water than the other guy. And washing in cold can save you 70% of the energy in each load. Cold Canadian temperatures, bring them on. Tide.
This period brought to you by BlackBerry, proud supporter of Canadian Interuniversity Sport.
You know, great story about Chris Culligan. He played with Taylor McDougall, the son of head coach Gardner McDougall, and as a result of getting to see him on multiple occasions by going to watch his kid play, he was able to recruit Chris Culligan to come here to UNB, and he has instantly become a fan favorite. That takes a lot of people to spell his name first and last, and add the number at the end. He's on the board first for UNB.
A shorthanded goal for Chris Culligan. Sam, Chris Culligan scored three goals in the AUS playoffs. They were all game winners.
Clutch. Doesn't surprise me. He's a smart player. I loved him as a junior in Cape Breton, and it doesn't surprise me to see him having that kind of success here in the CIS.
You've always been a huge fan. Backhander, Fullerton kicked it right out in front. And a penalty upcoming, and it's going to go to the Varsity Reds.
Well, there are no shortcuts in this game. Both teams really driving the net hard. And as a result of that, your defenders are forced to step up not only to protect your goalie, but to protect the net. And Luke Gallant will take the penalty. It's that last little shove at the end. Even though it's Gallant as the guy who goes down, he's the one who ends up getting the gate. Good job there by Furlong, who's been very effective in this game.
Gallant takes his seat. And with 13:08 to go in the second period, a fourth power play for the University of Western Ontario. Alberta really struggled today against McGill on the power play. That was a key difference in that contest. While McGill scored a couple of power play goals en route to the 6-3 win that earned them a berth in tomorrow night's title game. We'll have that for you. 8 o'clock Atlantic, 7 Eastern, 5 Mountain, here on Rogers Sportsnet. Stammer, solid jolt on Turkowicz. McQuaid to the line and Scott Arson. McQuaid, who rang one off the bar earlier in the period. In the slot, Turkowicz, a great setup and a shot for Keaton Turkowicz in Fullerton.
Great read by Turkowicz, who's working in the low slot, but knowing that he's going to get the puck back, he has to slide off his check in the middle of the ice, steps back to a little more towards the middle of the slot, accepts it, releases it quickly, but Fullerton not giving one inch once again. Beautiful play by Turkowicz and a nice feed to get the puck to him.
Turkowicz, 4 goals in the Ontario University Association playoffs to go along with his 14 during the regular conference play. Another shorthanded chance, this one for Ryan Seymour, and Greco makes the save and hangs on.
You know, Gardner McDougall separates his forwards into 6 energy forwards and top 6 forwards. And here it's the energy forward Seymour with the opportunity, able to push it out over the line. And again, although it's a shot from far out that Greco is easily able to stop, it gets the faceoff in to the offensive zone.
Shot attempt off the faceoff by Seymour out there with Matt Villier. Baker to McQuaid. Avoids a check from Desnoyers. Turkowicz, excellent effort to attempt to hold it in, and Tremblay knocked him off the puck and made sure it left his own. Turned over Arson. Seymour! And a blocker save by Greco, and a huge one by the Brampton Ontario native. Back comes McQuaid. Still plenty of time left in this man advantage. Hits Tremblay with a wrister. Arson backpedaling, watched closely by the guy who scored shorthanded, Culligan. Killing to center ice, shot in by Yasher Farmanara. McQuaid collides with Tremblay. Culligan can't one-hand it out. Farmanara to kill it. He sweeps it to Steve Reese. Baker now takes a long look. Killing wires it wide. Reese, tough pass, and out it comes to the neutral zone. And the penalty to Gallant is over. Yasher Farmanara from a sharp angle off the stick of Jonathan Hardy. And out of play it goes.
UNB serving notice shorthanded, and here, puck in the middle of the ice. Arson swinging to miss, his head up, allows Seymour to come in, and Greco gets out there at the last second and just is able to get the top right edge of that blocker on it and steer it wide. Boy, that could have really been nightmarish for Western, giving up two shorties, but Greco there to save the day on the second chance.
Greco's stopped 12 of 13. Travis Fullerton has faced 10 Western shots. The one shorthanded goal standing tall in this semi-final affair. Technically, the sixth and final round robin game of this 2011 University Cup. Desnoyers to the line. Paltridge knocked it down for his partner, Swift. Swift on the wing for Corbeil. A couple of weeks ago, Corbeil was the defensive player of the week in the National Lacrosse League with the Buffalo Bandits.
Yeah, on the all-rookie team last year.
Furlong, a chance to tie it and just miss. And it figures he's been a real spark plug for Clark Singer's crew. Greenside. Brandon Greenside. Good lead pass. Finds Kyle Lamb. Lamb off his stick. And Fullerton hangs onto it.
There's Corbeil getting in Seymour's face, really trying to stir it up. Upset after that hit he took on the Josh Kidd penalty. And showing a little vim and vigor in his game now. Furlong has been highly effective for Clark Singer. Playing third line minutes right now. Gets this puck on end, unable to corral it. But a good opportunity nonetheless. As Fullerton was in position, but had that puck been flat for Furlong, might have been a different result.
Furlong in his second University Cup. Three assists in the 09 tournament in Thunder Bay. Kyle Lamb handles, puts on the brakes in front for Reese. Loose, an opportunity, big save by Fullerton off of Chima Demore. Greenside wrister through traffic, and Fullerton found it and stopped it. It remains 1-0 UNB. Western almost draws even.
For the career options you want, the top salaries you expect, the opportunities you want to explore, we can get you there from here. UNB. Because there's only one, you.
Ladies, does the fresh scent of Fiji make your man smell like a never-ending tropical sunset? Personalized love song melody? Romantic puppy surprise? Yes.
It's the Nissan Now event, where we'll turn your standard model into a premium model with up to $2,100 in no-charge options. Plus, get 0% financing for up to 48 months. On the powerful 2011 Altima, with upgraded features like heated front seats, the spacious 2011 Versa, with upgraded features like AC, and the smooth 2011 Sentra, with upgraded features like 16-inch alloy wheels. So head down to your Nissan dealership now, before this offer ends March 31st.
You do your thing, leave the rest to us. Ramada Worldwide. Now, do your thing for less. Save 20%.
I live for the big hit.
Yeah, baby!
That's why I love the big hit of chocolate I get from Kit Kat Chunky.
Oh!
That's a lot of chocolate.
Crispy wafer and a big hit of chocolate. Have a break. Have a Kit Kat Chunky.
Guys, Pat Powers is the assistant coach for the Mustangs, and he applied for a vacant coaching job with the St. Thomas University Tommies. Now, there were 64 resumes that were sent to the Tommies. They're now down, apparently, to 20. And Powers, who went to St. Thomas University as a high school teacher in London, Ontario, says he wants to become a full-time head coach. He admits it's a bit nerve-wracking because it would be a life-changing affair for him. But he played 104 games with the Tommies, and, of course, right now his focus is with the Mustangs.
293 penalty minutes in those 104 games. And Clark Singer says, by all means, he's ready to take a head coaching job.
Kyle Lamb to the front of the net, knocked away by Gallant. It's a three-on-one for UNB. McIntosh, Campbell, Gallant, McIntosh, a quick whistle. Greco did not have control.
Well played. Very well played by Western. And the last thing you want to do is give up that odd man rush down 1-0. But this is just a great job as the puck goes down the other end of the ice. You'll see this three-on-one. They use the triangle, but down and making a great play defensively is the Western defender. McIntosh takes it to the front of the net, and it's Brandon Greenside, the defender for Western on that play, does a great job taking both passes away, forcing the shot on goal.
A look at Anthony Greco's work. He was Canada's starting goaltender at the World University Games in Turkey. Helped Canada to a bronze medal. Beat Belarus in that bronze medal game after losing to Russia in the semi-final affair. McIntosh off the draw, and Reese, his stick in the row. Campbell, Dion Campbell, backhander. This time there's no quick whistle as Clendenning nearly jammed it home. Look at these two teams go to work. Kidd, big shot off the body and just missed. McIntosh throws a jolt. And Desnoyers takes over. Antoine Desnoyers to Hunter Tremblay with speed. Tremblay, a hard blast right into the crest of Anthony Greco.
Well, you have to respect the speed of UNB, and when you do that, oftentimes you open up gaps. Here, Marc-Antoine Desnoyers springs Hunter Tremblay, but look at the gap here. Plenty of room to bring it between the circles and take that shot on goal. You have to respect the speed of Tremblay, and he takes full advantage of it, cutting into the middle of the ice for a good shot on Greco.
Tremblay so far, two-time CIS first-team All-Canadian, and the 2010 CIS Player of the Year has been shut out, but he's had some chances, as he always does. Fillier down low to McNeil with Kyle Bailey. Bailey's been a terror on the boards and on the draws in this game. Working against Turkowicz. Like a rugby scrum down there. Still going on. Bailey wins the battle. Stammler forced out at the line. And Fillier backhands it in. McNeil. Poked past him, Turkowicz. Stick lifted on the back track by McNeil. Here's Bailey into the zone. Bailey, slap shot. Good pick save by Greco.
It's amazing what the back track will do for you. McNeil picks it off in the neutral zone, and it's a two-on-two the other way. Another good scoring opportunity for UNB.
Terrific pivot by Hardy. Tremblay. Greco's been very solid. Tremblay to the goal getter, Chris Culligan. To Jonathan Hardy. Dean Todd to the front of the net, and Arson calmly, coolly intercepted it and cleared it. Heck of a play by Arson.
You mentioned it best, Peter. Arson really gives Western something that they lack, that really steady stay-at-home guy that can at times provide some offense for it.
Ben Wright dishes off. Culligan returns the favor. Wright go on with that big shot. Another shot blocked by Western. Tremblay by himself. Here comes McQuaid. Can he get to it? Josh McQuaid at the end of a lengthy shift. Has to be out of gas. This guy's not. Culligan steams in. Puts on the brakes. Has Wright as a trailer. Lost it to Greenside, but Wright keeps it alive. And Nemeth from Amherstburg, Ontario. to Farmanara through his legs. Under seven to go as Culligan still tied up behind the play and puts a grab on McQuaid.
Yeah, a lot of deeks going on there. Holds, clutches, grabs. A couple rabbit punches.
Waiting for a Ric Flair woo by the time that was done. And now there is going to be a penalty for interference. And Western about to enjoy its fifth power play chance.
And it couldn't come at a better time. Western reeling a little bit in its own end. Gardner McDougall's UNB V Reds winning races, as he likes to call it. Good chance for Hunter Tremblay. Has it go right between his legs on the pass from Culligan. And then it's Culligan behind the play, left side of your screen. He and Josh McQuaid get tied up. Look at McQuaid doing the deke, holding him. Little rabbit punch. Culligan gets in his road. Another rabbit punch. All right, now we'll both go to the bench. And the penalty called there as Wright gets the gate for UNB. And a huge time for Western to go on the power play.
0 for 4 are the Mustangs, and they've given up the lone goal while on the power play, a shorthander at 5:28 of this frame to Chris Culligan, his first of this CIS University Cup.
Yeah, Clark Singer looking now and watching his club continuously getting beat in the faceoff circle, and that is especially key when you're on the power play. You need to get that initial possession in order to get things set up. That has been a sore spot all game long for Western.
Singer sending his troops out. Reese, an all-rookie team member in the OUA. 15 goals in conference action.
And another win there by Bailey, and kills more time off the clock for UNB.
Gardner McDougall makes no bones about how hard this team works on winning faceoffs as part of their possession-oriented game.
Really tough now for Western to get penetration into the offensive zone. They'll get a bit of a break here as the puck's chipped into the Western bench, and now the faceoff will come all the way inside UNB's end.
10th appearance in this tournament for the Western Ontario Mustangs. One title to their credit in 2002. And a 4-2 setback to UNB in the championship game in 09 in Thunder Bay. Tonight, a semifinal affair for the right to play McGill, a first-time member in a University Cup title game tomorrow night. Turkowicz into the zone, stood up by Jonathan Hardy. Arson back deep to regroup. Seymour backs out now. Arson up the middle to Turkowicz. Off the stick of Luke Gallant. Stamler first to it. And knocked down by high sticks of the faceoff deep in UNB territory.
Peter, want to talk a little bit about the faceoffs. The visiting team here is the Western Mustangs. They're forced to put their stick on the ice first. And when they make that little move, as Lamb did there, that's seen as an advantage. So you'll get tossed out of the faceoff circle every time that happens. It is all incumbent upon the visiting center to get his stick down, be in position, and not move it. Therefore, the slight edge goes to the home team. In this case, it's UNB. 14-1 in faceoffs this period for the Varsity Reds, only because they're a little bit quicker on the draw when the visitors have to wait for the puck to be dropped.
Bailey in deep on the forecheck, shorthanded. Kevin Baker, the return pass from Arson. And the former Oshawa General in Sudbury Wall cleared it in, only to have it sent back down the ice. 30 seconds to go. And the lack of power play productivity becoming an issue in this game for the Mustangs. However, with their one shot away from drawing even in the game. And they'll have to go deep to regroup again as Greco, no trapezoid in CIS hockey, so the goaltender free to go and play it wherever he would like. Short side, and there looked to be some room. Hardy, high shot. Greco didn't see it, but well wide of the target. Stamler moves in. Kicked away by Greco, and another penalty kill for UNB. Culligan with Campbell and Tremblay. Hunter Tremblay trying to work to the net. Wraparound. Another shot by Trombley, and Greco has an answer for both. He's a significant reason this is a 1-0 hockey game. Bolmanera knocked down, another penalty. Upcoming to the Varsity Reds. The crowd doesn't like it. 1-0. Almost 2.
Once I know someone has a BlackBerry, I'm pretty eager to trade my BVM pin with them.
That's the first step, is to get their pin and continue the conversation on BlackBerry Messenger.
You can see when your message has been delivered, when they've read it.
He's writing a message.
You can never respond too quickly. Gotta be hard to get.
You can send voice notes, pictures.
It's almost like they're right next to you.
BVM helps you build a relationship and flirt.
Last night, huh? So what happened to you? Last I heard, you were headed for some body piercing place. Man, that stuff's too weird for me. Anyway, I'm sure you didn't do anything too stupid. Hey, you're the man, cool guy. See you at the beach.
The Sears Dress Up Look Great event starts this weekend. Buy more and save more, up to 40% on women's and men's suits, pants, jackets, and shirts, including great brands like Jones & Co., Ellen Tracy, Liz Claiborne, Chaps, and Hagar. Starts this Saturday, so don't miss it. Dress up and look great at Sears.
Over here. Put your roots in reverse.
With Root Touch-Up by Nice and Easy, it extends the life of your color in 10 minutes.
With a seamless match to any brand. Guaranteed.
Roots are out of there with Root Touch-Up by Nice and Easy.
For basketball fans, coming up later this evening on Sportsnet 1, it's the Toronto Raptors taking on the Los Angeles Clippers, and the human highlight reel, Blake Griffin. This guy's been sensational, the rookie. I don't know about that costume. Pretty sensational for some.
A little look at the penalty as Culligan takes Farmanara down, and a little bit of an embellishment on the part of Farmanara. Throwing out the hands, getting the stick up in the air too. And Culligan back in the box for UNB.
So as the game's shorthanded goal getter sits down, another chance for Clark Singer's Mustangs. Turkovic in the corner, back out with Lamb, McQuaid, Baker, and Arson. The other thing about this game is you play your power play players so much, and if they don't score, it makes it difficult, especially when you're trailing.
Well, that's just it, but Western has to find a way here with the extra man. And this is something that they haven't been able to do, and that's get possession for an extended time in the offensive zone while on the power play.
Lamb, McQuaid in front, Turkovic in the slot, shot it over top of the net. There's a good wrinkle. We saw it a little earlier on a power play. McNeil is a little fatigued, maybe right there from Baker as he lost the handle to McNeil.
Baker's such a gifted playmaker, so he gets to play the point here for Clark Singer on the power play.
This power play first unit has been out there a lot because they've been on the power play a lot. Fillier after a rolling puck. And Baker with his good speed. Seymour to it first. Ryan Seymour. Greco steered it away.
A lot of good chances given up by Western while a man down. And that's because UNB won't just send the one man in to chase the puck here. It'll send two.
Off the bench comes Steve Reese. Reese to McQuaid. Killing, tipped in front by Turkovic, just went out the other side. Ben Wright off the dasher board. Killing able to keep it alive at the line. Nice touch pass, Reese Turkovic, and a shot block, but it still made its way on target.
And there's McQuaid causing trouble after Fullerton's able to cover it up. But a great job by Reese, A, to keep this puck in, and B, to keep the puck alive. Keaton Turkowitz sliding off the check once again, has to take it off the skate. And the problem there, Peter, is the puck's a little too far ahead of him, gets too much leverage on the shot, and sends it high. See that puck way out in front of him? And that's what forces that puck to go wide, to go high, rather. And now Fullerton, after a pinballing-like puck, makes its way right to his chest.
Eden Turkowicz, two assists in the 09 University Cup so far, two assists in the 2011 version. And has had a couple of quality chances in this period to score for the first time in this event. Killing. Jason Swift. Killing on target, rebound, and Furlong brought by Fullerton. Culligan out of the box. Here's Bealey. A 2-on-1 type breakaway. Bealey brought by Greco. Anthony Greco again comes up large. Stops the captain. Kyle Bailey. Dejected as he makes his way to the bench. Pretty good hockey game here on a Saturday night of the University Cup. Dion Campbell, a steal. Campbell wheels in behind the net. Go on. That's blocked. Kidd at the right point. Josh Kidd and Furlong stop that. He'll ring it, but Gallant should hold it in. Does. Gallant on target. Greco found it and stopped that too.
Good play by Farmanara. Support defensively. Calmly puts it behind the net. Now Western has no choice but to relieve the pressure. Wow. Action at both ends of the ice. Fullerton has to come up big here. Furlong with the rebound. Now the puck goes back to the point. Watch this chip by Culligan. Simple chip between the legs off the boards. That springs Kyle Bailey. You think he has it, but Greco gets a piece of it, sending it over the net. Kyle Bailey that close to making it 2-0, and the Varsity Reds would continue. But a good job by Farmanar to come back defensively.
Kyle Bailey, a scoring leader along with Lachlan McIntosh in the 2009 event. He had 6 points in three games. Culligan a little shot from behind. They didn't like that here in Fredericton, especially with all the penalties going the other way. Loose in front, Trombley tied in a knot by Nemeth, but got away. Culligan for a second. And closing the pads in a hurry again is Greco. As UNB starting to pile up the shots, that's their 23rd of the game.
Oh, so dangerous. Chris Culligan asking for a penalty on the play, and here's why. Right side of your screen, he gets pushed into the end boards on this cross check, but he doesn't give up on the play. Instead, goes back to the front of the net, takes the feed from Hunter Trombley, and again, a shot in tight against Greco.
Chris Culligan in the playoffs, all he has delivered is with game-winning goals. Might he have another one tonight? Kidd, he has a game-winner. Clendenning, sharp angle try. Greco got over from post to post. Trombley, Clendenning versus Chima Demore. Culligan again. When the UNB cycle game is at its best, it is menacing. Western trying to corral it. Kidd hustles to hold it in. Penalty now upcoming to Western. Kidd! And again, closing the wickets in a hurry was Anthony Greco.
You know what happens, Peter, when you get that increased pressure, that constant pressure, at some point you're going to be fatigued as a defender. And here, Julian Chima Demore is the guy who will go to the box. Right beside the net. You see the UNB player taken out of the play. Chima Demore goes to the box, and that is only because Western has been hemmed up here for the last 2 minutes in their own end, and the defender's awfully tired. Chima Demore gets called for roughing.
Just 12.4 to go in this period as Clark Singer takes a glance at the score clock here at the Aitken Center. This building will host next year's University Cup as well, and an important clear by Yasher Farmanar, and that should do it for period two. A tough one-hopper at the buzzer.
Fantastic period of play. UNB really starting to find its legs, assert itself. Greco's just been dynamite for Western. Western needs to find a way in this third period to be better on the special teams.
Play of the second period is brought to you by the Home Depot. Proud to support hockey in your community. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
Turnover by Western here on the power play. Turkowicz sends it across to what he thinks is a D-to-D pass. Instead, it's picked off by Chris Culligan in great position. Uses his body to screen the defender, Killing, and then goes blocker side, beating Greco for the lone goal in this game.
To the winner, a berth in tomorrow night's championship game versus McGill. UNB would love to be there. They lead Western 1-0 after 40 minutes.
Looking for a chance to break away. The future is yours.
unexpected. Oh yeah, discover the unexpected.
The book says, when faced with an aggressive raise from early position, only strong starting hands should be played. Lesser hands, such as draws and small pairs, should be folded.
Sometimes you gotta go with your gut. We play at fulltiltpoker.net. Come play for free.
Ever since we went online with Yellow Pages Group, business has been great. Our search engine marketing campaign has driven tons of leads. And we're getting amazing results.
Yeah, the business is growing. I'm even thinking of expanding.
I guess you could say things are looking up. Because we're up?
Yeah, I get it. Okay.
From websites to online marketing, reach more customers with Yellow Pages 360 solution. It's smart business for any business.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home.
Ivanka Osnak in the Connected Studios. Great pace to end the second period. You know it's going to be a battle in the third period. Speaking of battles, that's what we've got in the NHL with playoff implications in every single game, especially for the Leafs doing some scoreboard watching and watching their own score. They are in Detroit facing the Red Wings. James Reimer riding a personal four-game win streak, allowing just six goals. First period, Red Wings on the power play. And Henrik Zetterberg taking the pass from Nicholas Lidstrom. It's a 1-0 Wings lead. Late in the period, Leafs tie it up. Nazem Kadri, wow, tries to center but gets it right back, fires his short side, his second NHL goal. We are all tied at one in the second period. Meanwhile, how about the Sabres trying to hold on to eighth spot in the East? They are 5 points up on the Buds and looking for a third straight win. They get off to a quick start. Scramble in front, puck comes loose. Nathan Gerby firing it past Martin Brodeur. And Bilo on the board, one zip. Sabres keep it coming off the faceoff. Jason Palmaville, he's denied, but Thomas Vanek banging on the rebound for his 26th, giving the Sabres a 2-0 lead. And that's where this one stands in the second period. Meanwhile, Carolina, they have won three straight, and they are 3 points behind Buffalo for eighth spot. Home and home against the Bolts. First period, Nate Thompson with a hit on Tuomo Ruutu. Thompson would go to the box, two for interference. Now, under the new NHL protocol, Ruutu heads back to the locker room and has to be assessed. Same period, we're tied at one. Simone Gagné, the steal, and then beats Cam Ward with the deke. And Tampa Bay takes the 2-1 lead. Carolina, though, gets that one back. Stillman the pass, and Eric Cole backhands it past Mike Smith to tie it back up. We are still at that score in the second period. At the Bell Center, Canadians hosting the Capitals. The Habs, fresh off their worst performance of the season, that 7-0 loss to Boston, facing the Capitals, who have won 11 of their past 13. Visitors look to strike first. Nicholas Backstrom, the initial shot, and Marco Sturm. He buries his first as a member of the Capitals, 1-0, and that's still the score in the second period. Let's go to the diamond. John Farrell's Jays taking on the Philly split squad. Skip to the third, now 2-0, and Jose Bautista rips the Kyle Kendrick offering down the line. That would bring in Adam Lind, so Jays with a 3-0 lead. Top five, same score. Ryan Matson on in relief, and Rajay Davis, see ya, over the left field wall, solo shot. They go up 4-0. They end up winning this one. It got pretty close. 7-6 final over the Phillies. Phil, Mr. Wonderful Davis, takes on Antonio Rogério Nogueira tonight on UFC Fight Night 24, and you can catch it on Sportsnet East, Ontario, West, and Pacific tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern. For now, we'll send it back for third period action. Enjoy the rest of the game.
We're the Schultzes.
The brother and sister photography team.
Being photographers, images are really important to us, and so we'll try to take in as many movies as we can.
And Point is great for that.
It automatically knows where you are.
You're going to interrupt me right now?
Uh-huh.
Go for it.
And it'll tell you what movies are playing around you.
On BlackBerry, it's a super app. You can watch movie trailers, purchase tickets on the phone. It's put in my calendar. It gives you a little golden ticket, and you're good to go.
Thank you.
More than apps, super apps. Only at BlackBerry App World.
It's the BRP Ultimate Playground Spring Fever event. For a limited time only, get up to $2,000 back on select BRP products, along with our lowest financing rates. Plus, get industry-leading warranties on Ski-Doo snowmobiles, Evan Rudy Tech outboards, Sea-Doo watercraft and boats, and Can-Am ATVs, side-by-sides, and roadsters. But you'd better hurry. The offer ends April 17th. Visit your local BRP dealer or brpultimateplayground.com for details.
Want a travel card that knows no boundaries? Welcome to the world of yes. Paris last minute? Yes. Book any travel on your card, then pay for it with points? Yes. Transfer your points to frequent flyer programs and one-to-one to Aeroplan? Yes. Earn double points on many travel and everyday purchases? Yes. Want a card that can do all that? Get the new American Express Gold Rewards card. The first year's on us.
Is this old stuff really important?
Of course. It made us who we are. Even before our flag, the maple leaf was a symbol of upholding our traditions. There's the Victoria Cross, awarded to the bravest soldiers who protected our democracy. And our great story continues, because the best team wins when we play by the rules. Want to learn more?
A message from the Government of Canada.
Canadians have no problem being out in the cold. No self-respecting Canadian says, let's wait for a warmer day. Here, braving the cold is a national sport. You and your clothes embrace cold weather. Why not wash them in cold water? Tide does better at getting stains out in cold water than the other guy. And washing in cold can save you 70% of the energy in each load. Cold Canadian temperatures? Bring them on. Tide.
The University gold medal game goes on Rogers Sportsnet on Sunday night. McGill is there for sure, but will it be Western and or UNB? That remains to be determined. 40 minutes in the books here at Fredericton. UNB up 1-0. I'm joined by the Varsity Reds captain, Kyle Bailey. And Kyle, maybe first of all, your breakaway at the end of the period there with 2 minutes left. You score there, you make it 2-0. You guys have had a lot of chances.
Yeah, that's a tough one. Sort of similar to Culligan's goal there. And a little tired, was out there for a little extended. But, I put the shot right where I wanted to. The goalie made a great save on it. It's too bad. It would be nice to go in with a 2-0 lead, but we'll take the lead after 40 minutes.
You're certainly taking it to them, so I guess you really like what you're doing. However, you're taking a lot of penalties. You guys are spending a lot of time in the box, and although you're pressuring Western, is that something you think you need to be doing a better job of, is staying away out of the box?
Yeah, I mean, anytime you take as many penalties as we did that period, I don't know if it was 4 or 5 or something like that, that's, you don't want to spend 8 or 10 minutes shorthanded in a period. It makes for a tough period, but we're getting a little bit of momentum off our kills. It seems like we're having really good shifts when we get back to 5-on-5. Just like to keep it at 5-on-5 for a little more extended period of time, I guess.
And you start period number 3 on the power play.
Yeah, it's huge. I mean, obviously we'll go in the room and talk about it and hopefully set something up and then capitalize and go from there in the third.
This is your hurrah, last hurrah at least with UNB. Whether you're playing tomorrow remains to be determined, but what does it mean for you? I know you have family members in the stands, but I mean, for you to have been here and to get a chance to play for the gold medal game.
Oh, it's been unbelievable. I mean, we're only still got a little bit of journey left, hopefully, anyway, and it's been unbelievable, everything I could ask and more, and I've enjoyed every day here over my 4 years, and I'm just trying to enjoy these games as much as I can, and hopefully we're successful, and hopefully the team can walk forever.
Thanks so much for this. Best of luck in the third.
No problem. Thanks, Louis.
There's Kyle Bailey, captain of the UNB Varsity Reds, and here's a look at his breakaway late in the second period, but was unable to capitalize. Still, UNB is up 1-0 after 2.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming.
UFC Fight Night follows immediately after tonight's game here from Fredericton. It is David versus Nogueira on Rogers Sportsnet, 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 Pacific. We hope you'll join us as we take you right back inside the Aitken Center here in Fredericton, New Brunswick, joined by Maury Guerra, the head pro scout of the Edmonton Oilers. And I'm sure that a few years ago, we wouldn't have seen a lot of NHL scouts at this particular event. Why all of a sudden are we seeing more and more NHL teams here?
Well, I think it's the quality of play, to be honest with you. I think you've seen some players come out of this tournament that are playing quite well in the National League right now. So, I mean, it's an opportunity for us to get a look at these players. They've been scouted before, but some of our amateur guys have highlighted some guys, and so it's an opportunity for us to come in and maybe see what they might be like as pros.
Maury, what are you specifically looking for? I mean, do you need players to be dominant at this level to hopefully make it to the next?
Well, yeah, you're looking for a player that can dominate at this level. I think you're looking for the whole package, the ability to the skill set, the skating, the size and strength, hopefully, and then you just see how they read and react in the game and their hockey sense, and we look for a lot of things that we look for in pro players.
And I guess one of the nice things as well for NHL teams is the fact that these are freebies. You don't have to give up draft picks or anything like that for players like these.
No, that's right. And I think at this point in our organization, we have our own farm team again in Oklahoma City, so we're looking to put players there. And I think the Oilers are in a rebuilding phase, so we're looking for players that maybe we can create depth in our organization. And you never know. I mean, a player, everyone develops at a different pace, so someone might come out of this tournament and eventually play for the Oilers.
Are you going to throw out any names for us just to make it interesting?
Well, not really, because we don't like to give away our trade secrets. You know, it's, I mean, it's not that hard to figure out. There's good players here, and, I mean, you can see them on television, and those are the players that I think we're keying in on, and hopefully someday maybe they'll be in our organization.
You have been here in Fredericton since last Thursday. Tell me a little bit about what you've seen so far. Are you impressed by the caliber play? In particular, this till tonight's been amazing.
Yeah, the hockey's been excellent. The competitive balance has been great. A lot of close hockey games. I've just really enjoyed the hockey. I've enjoyed the atmosphere. The people here are really knowledgeable fans and really seem to embrace this whole tournament. So, no, it's been a great experience. I've really enjoyed it, and it won't be my last one, that's for sure.
Maury, thanks so much for this. Greatly appreciated.
No problem. Thank you.
That's Maury Guerra, the head pro scout of the Edmonton Oilers. We've got 40 minutes in the books. The last period coming up between Western and New Brunswick. UNB up 1-0.
Did you know that James Naismith, the inventor of basketball, was a McGill alumnus? And that indoor ice hockey was first played by McGill students in 1875? Football had its beginnings in a game played between McGill and Harvard back in 1874. Over the past century, McGill athletes have combined to win 7 university national championships, 28 Olympic medals, and 31 Stanley Cup titles. Who knows what future remarkable achievements await our student athletes?
I'm in here for the rest of my life.
My wife's innocent. Where there's a will.
I promise you, this will not be your life.
There's a way out.
Do not do this.
We have no other choice.
Russell Crowe. The next 3 days. Own it today.
You used to pick up your phone and say, hello. Now you say, hello. The ridiculously big screen on the HTC Desire HD. You have never seen anything like this before. Exclusively at TELUS.
The 2011 University Cup on Rogers Sportsnet is brought to you by Cavendish Farms, providing high-quality frozen potato products to Canadians for over 30 years. By BlackBerry, proud supporter of Canadian inter-university sport. And by The Home Depot, proud to support hockey in your community. The Home Depot, more saving, more doing.
Second period summary is brought to you by BlackBerry, proud supporters of Canadian Interuniversity Sport.
Well, that's the difference in this game. Chris Culligan, Shorty, at the 5:28 mark, has stood the test of time through 40 minutes.
And here's a look at Chris Culligan and the game's lone tally.
Nice recruiting job there to pick up he and McNeil, both from Cape Breton. And a job by Turkowitz here, trying to go D to D. Instead, Culligan in fine position, uses the body to shield Jeff Killing. Has blocker side on Greco for the lone goal in the game.
Culligan to start the period on the power play. 1:48 left in a Chima DeMore minor that he picked up late in the frame as they work on the ice here at the Aitken Center. No shortage of activities, two games a day for the last 3 days.
And then all the practices going back to Tuesday when all the teams arrive. Five of the six teams practice here in the Aitken Center ice over Tuesday and Wednesday. A sixth team, St. FX, came in from Antigonish and also practiced. And so this is ice has seen a lot of wear and tear here dating back to Tuesday. Not to mention the wear and tear from a five-game AUS final where three of those games were played right here.
While they continue to mend the ice from one cup to another. The 2011 MasterCard Memorial Cup at the Hershey Center in Mississauga should be a fantastic field. We know the host team, the Mississauga St. Mike's Majors, will be there. Dave Cameron's team, who will join them. Tickets available. You see the number on your screen, and of course, we'll have all the games for you starting Friday, May 20th. When the host team, the St. Michael's Majors, tangle with the winners of the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League.
And most people from this area, just a short drive away, think it'll be the St. John Sea Dogs. A big win last night, up again 7-1 tonight against Cape Breton in a 1-versus-16 matchup.
A 57-win season, I believe, for the St. John Sea Dogs. One of the best regular season marks in Canadian Hockey League history.
Gerard Gallant, the head coach for the Sea Dogs. And you look at this Western bench, really struggling on the power play in this game. And Western will come out of this third period. A man down for 1:48 as Julian Chima DeMore sits in the box. Western Mustangs 2002 have their championship. Made a berth in the final in 2009, losing to these very same UNV Varsity Reds. And you know, Peter, what's really interesting, when you look at UNB, Gardner McDougal taking no chances with his hockey club at all. So he decided to put him up in a hotel, sequester them away from all of the madness that surrounds the Aitken Center here. The entire town talking about this, expecting this to happen. Gardner McDougal, on a couple of occasions this year, made his schedule a 3-4 to try and simulate what he might see here at the University Cup. And if this score holds through to the end, that's exactly the task that they will be faced with when playing in tomorrow night's championship. Of course, they're still 20 minutes away from achieving that feat.
The number two rated team in the country, the McGill University Redmen, will be the opponents of the winner of this game tomorrow night in the championship final of the 2011 University Cup. Hunter Tremblay and the rest of the UNB Varsity Reds trying to earn a berth in the title game for what would be, Sam, the fourth time in the last 5 years. They did not advance to the tournament last year despite a 27-1 regular season record.
Second last game of the year.
Upset in three straight in the semifinal in Atlantic Canada in the playoffs by St. FX. And then St. FX went on to lose a tough series to the eventual CIS champions from St. Mary's. Third period underway, and so is a UNB power play. Tremblay to Culligan. Hardy again moving down low. Luke Gallant and Kyle Bailey. Hardy stays in front of the net. Bailey works his way back down to the line, and Gallant scores! And UNB has an early power play marker.
Isn't this interesting, Peter? It's Jonathan Hardy, the defenseman, who's providing the screen for Greco. And in fact, heard the yells from the referee, Brent Holdsworth, the down low referee, to say, get out of the crease. And as you watch Hardy, watch him set up shop in front of the net. He's on the right side of your screen, number 40. When the puck, now he's in the way, now they yell at him, hey, get out of the crease, get out of the crease. So he makes sure that he makes those steps above the crease and provides the perfect screen. As this puck goes back to the point, it's Hardy providing the screen. It goes off the post and then off the stick of Luke Gallant.
Luke Gallant, no points in his previous two CIS University Cup appearances, has his first goal and his second point. The product of Bedford, Nova Scotia. A power play goal at the 45-second mark. And the number one rated team in the country with a 2-0 third period advantage.
You can't give Jonathan Hardy enough credit. I mean, when you stick a smallish defenseman in front of the net to provide the screen, you know he's a real pain in the rear end. Bailey gets it back to the point. Gallant with the shot. And the screen provided by number 40, Jonathan Hardy, in front.
Stambler, a weak wrister. Blocker down as it came off the end glass by Greco. He's been terrific in the game. Fillier to Stambler. Fillier again. Jordan Clendenning with Nick McNeil. McNeil using his size. And Nemeth plays it ahead to McQuaid. And now the home folks are really involved. Baker to Turkowicz. One thing about this Western group, they won't go away. McQuaid throws a hit on Clendenning, and he'll be penalized. And he doesn't like that call very much. So UND, who just found the net on a power play, will go back to another.
And McQuaid's lucky he didn't get another. He came right at Clendenning and gave him the business.
Hardy into the zone to Kyle Bailey. Bailey, a rough ride from defenseman Matt Paltrich.
And no question, this is an interference call. McQuaid, who was one of the yappers for Western at the start of this game, has let the emotions get the best of him. You see, as the puck comes free, it's McQuaid providing the hit, but the puck has already left the boards. And Josh McQuaid, who has been so instrumental in this run for Western to get here, takes the penalty here with Western already down 2-0.
Kyle Bailey and Chris Culligan, his second point of this semifinal affair. The assist on the power play goal by Luke Gallant, his first in University Cup play. And UNB with an opportunity maybe here to deliver a knockout punch. Gallant into the zone again. Lost the handle and his balance in killing an opening and slides it down the ice. Marc-Antoine Desnoyers leads the power play breakout up the ice to Gallant. Off the stick, onside to Culligan. To Gallant. Desnoyers. Tremblay in the high slot area. Bailey now. The captain. Rocket pass. Bailey and the give and go off the outside of the net. And cleared by Brandon Greenside as Clark Singer will make changes. So will Gardner McDougall. Nearly 3 minutes into this third period. The McGill Redmen, who earned their first ever title game berth earlier today with a 6-3 win over the University of Alberta, await the winner of this game in tomorrow night's title affair. Josh Kidd. Carson to it first, to Corbeil. Off Dane Todd, and it belongs to Jason Furlong. Furlong's been one of the best Western Ontario forwards here tonight. Kidd to McNeil. With Clendenning. Jordan Clendenning into the zone. McNeil can't corral the bouncing puck. Stambler drives it wide. Stambler again thought about it. Dishes for Hardy. Hardy is shot. A rocket-like blast off Greco. Might have hit him in the mask. Out of the penalty box comes McQuaid. So UNB unable to take advantage of this power play. And Western with a large kill. Stambler, shot blocked by Corbeil up the middle. Here comes McQuaid now, working against Hardy. Stopped by Thornton. That's a big save. That would have provided a real spark McQuaid, who just came out of the penalty box. Seymour let the puck go to throw a hit, and Kyle Lamb, a wrister, gloved by Fullerton, who's been solid, solid, solid in goal for UNB.
Jonathan Hardy all over the ice. First, he gets a big slap shot here. I mean, this is a rocket. I think it gets Greco on the mask. Back the other way, Josh McQuaid going in on Hardy, uses the body to shield him, and then he tried to go back across his body, but Fullerton was not giving an inch.
Culligan shorthanded in the second. Gallant on a power play early in the third. His switch shot on target. Lamb, nice pass down low on the wraparound, stopped by Fullerton. Chima Demore tried to find an opening, and here's Campbell again. Campbell with McIntosh and Seymour. Campbell. McIntosh hooks down his man. There'll be a UNB penalty. McIntosh can't believe it, but he's going to the penalty box.
Big Jason Swift, when he goes down, you know he's going to make a wave because of how tall he is, how long that stick is. And McIntosh, working to try and dig it out of his feet, ends up taking the penalty. And McIntosh pleading his case, saying, hey, all I'm doing is digging for a loose puck. And you'll see McIntosh on the right side of your screen. He gets involved with the bigger Swift, drags him down to the ice. For that, he is called. And this could be the big turning point in the game. Western has had no success at all on the power play, and they're going to have to get something done here.
So as McIntosh, who hails from nearby Perth Andover, sits down. Face-off wins of plenty for UNB. 30 out of 45, they won through two periods. Kyle Bailey, the best. 14 out of 19 draws, the captain won through 40 minutes. And this is power play chance number 7. At the end of this game, if Western Ontario is unsuccessful, they'll look back at their power play. But credit the UNB penalty killers. And they've scored shorthanded to boot. Kyle Lamb in the corner versus Hardy, and a clear by Cromwell.
A little too casual for my liking on Western's power play. There needs to be some urgency to get it into the offensive zone, get set up, and do some simple things that they were doing 5-on-5 to start this period. Just get some shots on goal. They have to get more shots Travis Fullerton's way.
Let's not forget their second game in as many nights. However, in the university scene, that's really how they play. They don't play all week long for the most part, and then play back-to-back in weekend series, if you're unfamiliar.
And that's coming off that 12-day layoff, the Queen's Cup hosted by Western, a 6-2 loss to McGill.
Reese on the power play, Baker to the line, and Jason Swift killing a drive, and the glove saved by Fullerton.
A little more of a positive result, but as Killing pulls this puck towards the near boards, it's Fullerton who has a perfect lane to see this puck. Swift with the pass. Now watch as Killing is backing up towards the boards. Lets it fly, but a good look there for Fullerton.
Fullerton, 17 saves. Posted 2 shutouts in the Atlantic University Conference playoffs. A 160 goals against average during the regular season. Reese backhands it. Farmanar in pursuit of Stamler. Trombley, good turn, but he can't clear. Baker, and a block by Culligan, who's done it all in this game. Goal and an assist. Killing. Another shot block, guess who? Culligan.
Culligan.
McIntosh out of the penalty box. Might have a break. Can't quite catch up to it. 7 power plays have gone astray for the University of Western Ontario. Swift up the middle. Jason Swift. Furlong backhands it behind the net. Gallant takes a bump. Nemeth holds it in. McIntosh on the boards, chops at it. Finds its way on the stick of Furlong. He'll shovel it down low towards Chris Corbeil. And Hunter Trombley sends it down the ice. Trombley, known for the offensive part of his game. He's made a lot of good defensive plays in this contest.
And you know what, Peter? I think that's something that Scheid scouts away from him during his junior career, but seemingly has that figured out here in CIS.
Nemeth, a redirect by Corbeil just over top of the net. Western in a very desperate situation now, but still 11:53 to go. The deficit two. Campbell would like to make it three. Stopped by Greco. Kidd down low. Campbell to a loose puck. Dion Campbell. McNeil off the bench trying to get to the net. Scored five times during the Atlantic Conference playoffs. Delier, his shot. Low and wide.
Noyer with some great offensive flair. Showed it off to the Drummondville Voltigeur.
Kidd, former Erie Otter.
Former seventh round pick of the LA Kings in the 07 draft.
Hardy to Kyle Bailey. Safe play off the boards. You'll see a lot of that from Gardner McDougal's men the rest of the way, one would think. Swift back to it. To Hannigan. Randy Hannigan. Intercepted. The Culligan man. Another shot by Chris Culligan. With McIntosh. Culligan keeping it alive on the boards. I bet he gets a high player ranking in this game.
Probably the highest for UNB.
A team that does rank its players, as I think most teams do, after every game.
Coaches will sit in the room, they'll rank the player, and then they'll watch the video to make sure they were right on their original ranking.
McQuaid, a wrister, loose puck cleared out of harm's way by Ben Wright, and another penalty, a cross-checking call to UNB. Western, back to the power play when we return.
The Sears Dress Up Look Great event starts this weekend. Buy more and save more, up to 40% on women's and men's suits, pants, jackets, and shirts, including great brands like Jones & Co., Ellen Tracy, Liz Claiborne, Chaps, and Hagar. Starts this Saturday, so don't miss it. Dress up and look great at Sears.
Did you see that?
You really should get that repaired before it cracks. Relax. I'm calling Speedy Glass.
Hi, Speedy Glass.
Yes, it's for a chip repair?
I have a spot right now if you like.
Now?
Yeah.
And there you go. Your windshield is as sturdy as it was before.
Amazing. And because your insurer covers you for glass damage, it's free.
Thanks, then.
My pleasure. Call now or book online at speedyglass.ca.
If you enjoy watching young, up-and-coming prospects, tune in tomorrow, the final of the OHL Cup, 2 o'clock Eastern, 11 o'clock Pacific. That's on Sportsnet Ontario. These are the stars of the 15-year-old age group. And, Sam, I watched a lot of these kids play in Halifax at the Canada Winter Games, and I'm here to tell you there will likely be some stars of the future in that game. I'm not kidding. That is a good group from a province that's really in a great cycle.
Right on Killing with the cross check. So he goes to the box. Western again on the power play. And I couldn't agree with you more. I attended the camp for Team Ontario. Darnell Nurse. Max Domi. What a group of players. Jordan Subban, the youngest of the three Subban brothers.
And is he ever good?
Oh, yeah.
Now, not to say that those kids will necessarily be in the final, but there will be some high-end young men you'll hear about for years to come. our good friend Rob Falds on the call of that game tomorrow from Toronto. Baker, McQueen, a wrist shot, Stammler in the road. He did everything he could to block that. Carson, low shot. Hardy a chance to clear and does so.
Man, Hardy has just been all over the place. Power play, penalty kill, in front of the net, in front of his own net. He's been everywhere.
He must sleep well at night. Off a leg. Kid can't clear. Lamb a chance. And Kid swept it away from Turkowicz, who was looking. Culligan again, shorthanded. What a boost! And goes upstairs over top of the net, looking for his second shorthanded goal of the game and what would have been his third point. He's been relentless. Gallant, who scored a power play goal earlier in this period, cleared it out. Farmanara carries in. And off Gallant's stick and out of play.
Good job by Luke Gallant with the stick, and that's something that UNB preaches, good stick work, and it all comes back to Josh Kidd. His stick work here, able to clear the road as this puck is right free in front of the net. You see Kidd sweep it out of the way. That led to that odd man rush. Culligan working his way in, looking for a second shorty of the game, fires it just high.
He's been terrific.
Best player on the ice.
No question. McIntosh to take the draw. Farmanara upset again. Another Western player waved out of the faceoff circle. A Western faceoff win this time late on the power play. Reese, Baker, Kevin Baker. From a sharp angle, flirting the save, an interception by McIntosh with Bailey. And Lachlan McIntosh, cross-corner shoot-in, and he'll make his way to the UNB bench. 8:20 to go in regulation. UNB that far from playing McGill in tomorrow night's title game. Farmanara, toe drag, and a kick save by Fuller. Reese off the boards. To Baker, he'll shoot it, and Fullerton with another save. And another penalty kill for Fullerton and UNB.
Looking for a chance to break away. The future is yours.
Hey, Dave. He's got another one.
Really? Man, he loves that sandwich. You worried?
Why would I be?
Well, you know, filet-o-fish, weir fish.
Nah, that's made with flaky Alaskan whitefish. We're just goldfish. Nobody wants to eat us.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, trust me. We've got absolutely nothing to worry about.
The one-of-a-kind filet-o-fish made with Alaskan pollock and served on a warm steamed bun. Get hooked today.
How many times has this happened to you? Well, never again with the Benchmark AccuraTape, only at Home Hardware and Building Center locations. The rugged 25-foot Benchmark AccuraTape features a pencil holder and a pinpoint marker for ease and precision. There's a magnifier for easier reading and an LED light for accurate measurement. The Benchmark AccuraTape. For good measure, it's just $17.97.
Homeowners, helping homeowners. Only at Home Hardware and Building Center locations.
Game summary brought to you by BlackBerry, proud supporters of Canadian Interuniversity Sport.
UNB special teams the difference in this one. 1-for-5 in the power play. They also have a shorthanded goal. In Western, there's no doubt that's been the difference. 0-for-10 all told in this tournament. And the Culligan man, he's been everywhere. A goal and an assist. And the best player on the ice for either team in this game.
And very close to another shorthanded tally on an 8th consecutive kill by the Varsity Reds. Bailey, Hardy, and McNeil, and a simple but effective chip out of the zone. Chris Corbeil knocked down on a solid hit by Jonathan Hardy again. That's about five or six that he's delivered. Three of them came in the opening minutes of this game.
They're really setting the tone for UNB.
Nemeth. Nice take by Corbeil at center to Furlong. Jason Furlong versus Gallant, who's been very steady.
Well defended there. Separated man from puck. Got the puck out.
Chris Rocca upended and another penalty. And kneeing will be the call. A rare shift for Rocca.
Yeah, he's given Clark Singer some good minutes here in this third period. He didn't play much in the first and second, but Rocca now is able to come in there and draw the penalty, giving Clark Singer some good minutes. Jonathan Hardy stepping up in the middle of the ice on Corbeil. And then the penalty, the move. Yeah, you have to call that. Rocca makes that inside move, and Kidd trying to upend him. Connects knee on knee. A dangerous play. Rocca went off slowly. Kidd went to the box. But here it is. What's it going to come down to? What it's come down to all game long. Is Western going to be able to score a goal in the power play?
Gardner McDougall hoping his team can hang on here. He will not want to take anywhere near this amount of penalties if his team survives this one tomorrow night against a high-scoring McGill team, the highest-scoring team in the country. And they found the net six times today in their win over Alberta.
Including a couple of power play marks.
Turkovic. Hardy slips it through to McNeil and almost a return penalty on Arson. And they're eligible.
You know, one thing I've noticed that UNB does, when their forwards get the puck at the line and the penalty kill, very rarely do you see them dump it down the ice. They want to possess the puck because they know if they have it, that Western can't. And this is the exact situation that happens here. Nick McNeil, there's no need to shoot that puck down. He decides to carry it, and when he does so, Arson steps up and does the exact same thing that just happened with Josh Kidd.
23 seconds into the Kidd penalty, Clark Singer's defenseman Scott Arson penalized. And the coaching staff is really hot at the Western bench.
Yeah, and I think they don't want to allow the line change. And so Kyle Lamb, who was out there with the visiting team again, not having the luxury of getting that last change, Lamb has to come out. Killing will go to the bench. And what this does, Peter, it puts three forwards out there for Western, and that's why Clark Singer is so concerned. Swit, the only defenseman of the group.
Against a team in UNB that has won a ton of draws, but Lamb won the draw. However, can Western clear the zone? Not so far. Now they will. And they'll attempt to get Killing on the ice as they slide it in on this four-on-four situation. Gallant with an important early power play goal in the third to go along with Culligan. Shorthanded goal. Culligan, a rocket, backhander, Tremblay! Pucked off the puck as he had an empty net to shoot into. That might have put this one to bed. Not so. Killing against Desnoyers. Gallant cross Killing with a shoulder check to the chest. McIntosh into the zone against Swift. Good burst by McIntosh. Stick handling it with that long piece of lumber or graphite. Swift took it away. Looks like the same stick that Willie Mitchell uses for the LA Kings. About that long.
It works for Swift, though.
Works for Mitchell, too. Nemeth takes a look up at the clock as all of a sudden time becoming an enemy for the University of Western Ontario. Reese, he can turn it around with his feet. Reese cuts to the net. Another penalty coming up. Interference is going to be the call. And Greenside better be careful. He's hot. And penalized. There's been some doozy hits in this one.
For the money you can make and the places you can travel, While you earn your degree, we can get you there from here. UNB. Because there's only one you.
And I want the stocks I picked to stop losing money.
If you stop picking stocks, maybe you'll stop losing money.
Getting what you want starts with the bank you choose. Want to invest for the long term? Ask for the Streetwise Fund from ING Direct.
Is this old stuff really important?
Of course. It made us who we are. Even before our flag, the maple leaf was a symbol of upholding our traditions. There's the Victoria Cross, awarded to the bravest soldiers who protected our democracy. And our great story continues, because the best team wins when we play by the rules. Want to learn more?
A message from the Government of Canada.
If you wait for a full load, 24 hours stuck on food can be a huge project. But not for Cascade All-in-One Action Packs. With 70% more tough food cleaning ingredients, it's Cascade's ultimate power tool for day-old stuck-on food. Cascade All-in-One Action Packs. Beyond your wildest clean.
Clark Singer's squad in trouble, trailing 2-0 in this semifinal affair, and now two men short for 21 seconds with the interference penalty to Brandon Greenside. A power play goal already in this period for UNB. Kidd, slap shot, takes a bite out of Nemeth, and Kidd can shoot it.
Oh, man.
Josh Kidd again. Dean Todd for Kidd. Gallant scores! Deflected in front. 3-0. The University of New Brunswick.
And now that penalty to Arson had just expired, and so really it was a 5-on-4 situation. Arson barely had time to get out of the box. Now Greenside comes out of the box. And a good shot from the point here. You saw Kidd loaded up before. This time he sets it up on a tee, and with that traffic in front of the net, no doubt it takes a bounce. And it either goes off the defenseman killing.
It might have hit Bailey.
Might have hit Bailey in front of the net. Either
or. I think
or.
It did.
But and the end result, a goal. And you could tell that it did hit something because of how slow it did enter the net.
Bailey's reaction tells me he's the goal scorer. Difficult to hear the announcement in a very noisy building. A second power play goal in this period for UNB in a game where special teams have been the story.
The difference period.
Two power play goals and a shorthanded goal. And Western with 8 or 9 power play chances in the game and unable, obviously, to capitalize. Fillier intercepted by Nemeth. Baker stopped up by Gallant, and Gallant with 2 points in the game now. Tremblay scores! Hunter Tremblay, and that most certainly will send UNB to tomorrow's title game.
Peter, this is a little bit like a shootout move. You see that leg lift, and once that leg comes up, that forces Greco to make the first move. Good burst of speed, leg lift right there, and that forces Greco to make the first move. When he does so, you see things open up, just that little bit of hesitation. Five hole is open. Greco wants to have that one back, and Hunter Tremblay picks up the fourth goal for UNB.
The CIS first team All-Canadian, his first goal of this 2011 University Cup. Gibbs, the number one rated team in the country, a 4-0 lead. And we are inching ever closer to a battle of 1 versus 2 for the University Cup in this building tomorrow night. And we'll have it for you right here on Rogers Sportsnet. A dejected Clark Singer. His team's created plenty of power play opportunities. They just have not been able to capitalize. And credit UNB, their special teams work has been sensational. Swit into the zone. Steered aside by Fullerton, and Fullerton has been so sharp. Even that play where it comes off the back glass and blockers it away immediately. And look out, this game could get really nasty. It's been very emotional, started in the warm-up. You don't want to see anything really get out of hand now.
And it did start in a warm-up, and from there, all the yapping raised the emotion of this game, and that helped UNB to capitalize early on.
Bailey, I believe, has been given credit for the power play goal, which would be his first of this University Cup. Kidd and Gallant to draw the assists at 15-12, and less than a minute later, Tremblay from Matt Fillier, and Gallant again. A three-point game for Luke Gallant.
You know, the UNB has used 11 different defensemen this year. Gallant in and out of the lineup with various injuries, but very effective here at the University Cup.
Gallant only played in four games in the postseason for the AUS champions. And games. A goal and two helpers tonight. And all of them in period three. I bet it's been a while since Luke Gallant had 3 points in one period.
You're right, Peter. And just 20 games played in the regular season as well. So it's been that upper body injury that's hampered Gallant. But here, finding a way to dig deep, knowing that in all likelihood he'll have just one game left for the remainder of the season. That will be the championship tomorrow night.
He did notch 56 points in his final year at junior with the St. John's Fog Devils. So it's not like he doesn't possess some offensive upside. And as we've witnessed tonight, he can shoot it. And another power play for UNB. Officially 2-for-7. Western 0-for-9. And yielded a shorthanded goal. Kyle Lamb. I believe they're chanting, "We want the cup."
Well, you're going to have an opportunity to play for it tomorrow night.
For the fourth time in 5 years, they'll play for it. Winners in 2009 in Thunder Bay.
Jordan Clendenning takes the elbowing call. It'll be interesting to see how Gardner McDougal manages his bench here. This is seemingly getting that edge where Western may just do a few things to draw some of the UNB players out of that final game.
Yeah, there's no love lost.
Nemeth takes the elbow and the chops. Clendenning, under the guise of finishing his check, ends up going off the elbow.
UNB 248 away from what would be their eighth appearance in a championship game at the University Cup in 11 appearances. Three titles they've won. Kidd drops it back to Gallant. 4-on-4 is the story right now with time winding down. McGill will play UNB for the title here tomorrow night. And while UNB has no shortage of experience in championship games, it will be a first for the McGill University Redmen.
Yeah, but doesn't it look like a little different McGill team? A team that's on edge that really went very matter-of-factly about their business in winning this afternoon against Alberta.
And they really have, as you mentioned earlier today, come into this event with a chip on their shoulder. Hardy slap pass block. Arson with an excellent recovery. Stamler, high wrist shot, he fires it wide. 1-0 was the score going into this, the third period, when Luke Gallant scored a power play goal 45 seconds in. Really paved the way. Hardy down low for Dion Campbell. Now Nick McNeil. Hardy returns it to McNeil as they start to sing the Na Na Hey Hey Goodbye song. The University of Western Ontario, winners of the OUA Western Conference, lost to McGill in the Queen's Cup Final in their 10th appearance. Seymour a shot. stop by Greco has been very good in goal for Western.
Yeah, no arguments there.
Can't even hear the whistle for Isaac. And if you think it's noisy in here tonight, wait till tomorrow.
It'll be a circus.
Sellout crowd. And somebody tell the fire marshal to leave town for tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
They'll be jammed into every crevice in this place.
I'll have to go back to the printing machine to try and find a few more tickets.
+3,700 have jammed in here tonight. Farmanara. In the last minute of this semifinal affair. Away from the puck, Farmanara is in all kinds of difficulty. And Sam, here's what you were talking about. If you're UNB, you need to stay disciplined.
No question, and that's why I think bench management here, even in 34 seconds, is going to be key. You know, UNB wanting to exact what they feel is a little revenge from some of the trash talking earlier in the game, from some of the stick work earlier in the game, but it has been equal on both sides. Top of the circle, and you'll see Farmanara get tied up. I think it's Jeff Lee of UNB.
Jeff Lee got his stick up on Farmanara, and he's grimacing at the bench. And Lee takes another penalty, so a last-minute power play for the Mustangs. McGill and UNB for the title here tomorrow night. Can't wait. Fillier had a second chance to backhand it out of the zone, and we'll let the people bring it home. The University of New Brunswick Varsity Reds win it 4-0, and some rough stuff at the end.
Yeah,
I believe Cooler, I think, maybe not. Ben Wright moved in now. The official's doing a good job. And the season is over for Western Ontario. Gardner McDougall's men, for the fourth time in 5 years, will play in the championship game of the University Cup.
Well, Kelly Nobbs and the McGill Redmen no doubt will be ready for that contest. I think everyone's got a little chip when it comes to playing UNB as the host, a little bit of that Yankees flair to them, and it should be one heck of a tilt here tomorrow night.
The bold move of the game is brought to you by BlackBerry, proud supporters of Canadian inter-university sport.
We have to go to Chris Culligan, who I feel was the best player on either team in this game. Shorthanded, picks off the Keaton Turkowitz attempt at a D-to-D pass, goes in shorthanded, uses a body to shield the defender killing away from him, and goes blocker side on Anthony Greco for our BlackBerry Bull move of the game.
4-0 the final. UNB to tangle with McGill for the title here in Fredericton.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm.
Once I know someone has a BlackBerry, I'm pretty eager to trade my BBM PIN with them.
That's the first step, is to get their PIN and continue the conversation on BlackBerry Messenger.
You can see when your message has been delivered, when they've read it.
He's writing a message.
You can never respond too quickly. Gotta be hard again.
You can send voice notes, pictures.
It's almost like they're right next to you.
BBM helps you build a relationship and flirt.
A perfect day. It is in the eye of the beholder. Found somewhere between the blue sky and the green grass. Lingering amongst the cheers that echo from the past. 500 times a year. In action. In resolution. and everything in between. It is always a perfect day for baseball. 500 Major League Baseball games on Rogers Sportsnet.
The player of the game is brought to you by Russell Athletic. Proven on the field of play, Russell Athletic is the official CIS Championship apparel supplier.
Chris Culligan of UNB just did everything in this game. You see a little board work after taking a shot from behind. He was all over the ice playing in both ends. Here, block shot, no problem. You want him to come back and backtrack defensively in his own zone, he'll do that for you as well. And then to cap things off while shorthanded, picks off his Keaton Turkowitz pass. He does a great job here to finish it off shorthanded. That really got UNB on its toes. It was the first goal for UNB, and it turned out to be the game winner.
Chris Culligan, a goal and an assist to help pave the way. UNB, a 4-0 triumph. They're 2-0. McGill is 2-0. They'll play for the title here tomorrow night, and we'll have it for you from Fredericton on Rogers Sportsnet. 8 Atlantic, 7 Eastern. Should be at Doozy. A sellout crowd was ready for a physical affair, and that's exactly what they received. A shorthanded goal, special teams, and a shutout for Travis Fullerton. The difference. Luke Gallant with 3 points. UNB title bound again. For Sam Cosentino, Louis, Jean, and the rest of our Sportsnet crew, hope you enjoy it. See you again tomorrow night.